Happy Halloween, everybody. It is Thanksgiving weekend, and we're getting ready for the birthday celebration. Happy Hanukkah to everybody. What's going on? Roxy Striar, how are you?
When's Hanukkah?
You're Jewish.
Yeah, but I think it's the second. I don't think we're here yet.
Did you hear what I started with?
Yeah.
You didn't hear the very
Happy beer. Christmas.
No.
Thanksgiving.
No. Happy Halloween.
It's all of it.
Is that what you muhahaha?
Yes.
It's all of it.
This is bad because I was reading the comments.
You're terrible at improv.
Yeah. I was reading the comments from yesterday, yes. And they're like, is Roxy even listening? And I literally was like, I listen to everything.
I wasn't just listening. No, you don't. It's nice to see you, Patricia. Now, over here, we got Mr. Josh Macuga. Welcome back to the actual show itself.
Hanging out in the mic's spot back there.
Did you like that?
The cops are spot. No.
No, you didn't like it at all. Felt like you were like punished or something?
I like it over there. I like those guys.
Right.
But I don't know when to chime in. And Cody's always messing with buttons over there. And he's really good on the buttons, but I don't know which buttons
it's
what.
The bench. Yeah.
Correct.
It's the bench.
Yeah, it's the bench.
Mark Reilly, how are you?
Hi, I'm good.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see everybody. Nice to hope everybody's having a wonderful day. Now, one of the things that I wanted to say, last week we had the stinky microphone that Roxy had. How's yours? Pretty good? Better?
It's getting worse. Not worse than it was, but worse than it was when we changed it.
I have a solution from now on. We brought some Febreze in here.
No, you can't spray it when it's on the mic. Oh, my God, Kristian.
It's fine.
No, it's not.
It's not fine.
It's not, dude.
It's right on the side. I didn't realize that the liquid came out.
We should have done this before we went on the air.
When that thing shorts out, we know why.
Oh, my God.
I've never seen...
You've been doing this for a decade, Kristian.
Dad's going to come in here and wring my neck.
And it's on camera.
I thought you can't even pretend.
No, spray it in the air.
Yeah, spray it in the air and push it down. That's what I was trying to say.
That's what I'm going to do because I'm not an actual crazy person.
I'm a moron. Yes. But look.
You're a special person.
It went straight up into the mic. Oh, so now
somebody
it's
was
better.
Legitimately just breathing on this with morning breath.
Yeah.
Well, now not anymore. Now is it better?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
Because now my nostrils are pierced with Febreze.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah, wow. It's really.
It's strong. Well, what would you rather have?
Not great ventilation in here.
Yeah. Well, now the whole room's going to smell.
I still think we should do something more like lavender.
That's what I'm saying. My wife sprays this lavender stuff on her pillow before she goes to bed at night. I don't know.
It's actually supposed to help you sleep.
Helps you sleep. Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes our bed smell amazing. I think the lavender spray in here would be a big deal, so I'm gonna have her order some.
Okay, let's do it.
Fall asleep though, or?
We should fall asleep. We have a really good show today. We have a bunch of things gonna talk about. Obviously,
good
we have,
intro there, pal.
I know. I was thinking about my head. You know what? I didn't have my coffee. Didn't kick in yet. I've had two cups.
It's a good show and a bunch of things.
We got a show and stuff.
Some things are gonna happen. Aquaman. The reactions to Aquaman have come in. We're gonna talk about that for sure. But speaking of other cool stuff and DC related things, I got a text the other day from our buddy Matt Serra, former UFC welterweight champion.
You guys are on texting terms.
You know what's funny about that is that I was listening. He told me he texted me to let me know. That he wanted to call back in. He said, hey, and he texted me, he said, I've been watching Titans on the DC app, and I want to call in and talk about it. And then he's like, and I also talked about you guys on UFC Unfiltered, his show. And I was listening to that, and we're going to talk about that because Dana White and John Jones were on it, and Dana White came in hot after Oscar De La Hoya, tore him to shreds.
Good.
And I want to talk to Matt about that too. But I did listen at the very end. And he was like, I was going to text him on Sunday, but he's with his family. I think I'm a lot closer with him than I really am. He said, and Jim Norton's like, yeah, he's probably, out with his family, getting blown. And I was like, Jim Norton.
Accurate?
Not on Sunday. Not on,
well, Tuesdays, clearly, but not on Sunday.
Not on Sunday.
Not on the Lord's Day.
No. But what was going on that, what is that? It's your birthday?
It's my birthday.
We're going to do sound clips.
If his birthday fell on a Sunday.
But Jim Norton, it was funny because Matt Serra was like, that show I listen to, Jimmy, the Collider Live, the Collider, I listen to it all the time. I tell him, he's like, yeah, I know it really well. Roxy asked him about Collider. What did he say?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Had no idea.
No idea.
Had no clue.
But that was before that conversation, though. Maybe I clued him into it.
No. Because he says yeah every single time. That's why I told you to bring it up.
He's a hard person to read. I've got to tell you, I can't tell when he's being sarcastic or when he's being serious.
I think that comes across in everything he's ever done.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Didn't you say he asked you out on the air?
Yeah, he did. He got my number on the air, and he texted me from across the room. What are you wearing? We were sitting in the same room, and he asked if I would get dinner with him. But he talks about pissing on women, or women pissing on him, and that for me.
Don't knock it till you try it.
That's what he said.
Jesus.
It's yeah, Kristian, is that true? You're such a jag.
You know, I just...
I just wanted you to see how fast you went. No, 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 no. It's a joke. Like yesterday, when we did, there was two jokes that were said.
Oh, my
God. What was the one? I said something like, I said, whatever we were talking about, I said, it's the Russian bots! About what the hell we were talking about yesterday.
About why they were Venom was getting more than Wonder Woman.
Yeah, and I go, it's the Russian bots! And see, some guy goes... Kristian, do you really think it's Russian bot? No, dummy! What did they say to you?
Oh, my God. They were like, see, Roxy just admitted they're all paid by Disney. That's why they don't say anything bad about Last Jedi. It was a joke.
It was?
It was a joke.
Is that a joke?
I make a joke.
But anyway, so the Jim Norton thing. Sorry.
Yeah, so he
says he likes to pee on people.
Yeah. I mean, I think he's a great guy. He probably is experienced in bed and could be a different kind of thing, but pee is off limits for me.
Yeah, as a
tribute. I'm closed off
unless
to
you're
pee.
Macuga.
Yeah, no.
Oh, boy.
Yes, no.
No. I mean, here's the thing.
Yes.
I appreciate my bedding and everything.
You can't pee in
beds. You can't be peeing in beds.
I don't understand. I never understand. I mean, I don't even want to talk
about it. Are you talking about on accident or you mean on purpose?
Both.
Both. Mm. Yeah. I learned a lot about Roxy. It had nothing to do with peeing, but I learned a lot about Roxy as she saw in 101. Before we knew it was an hour and like 40 minutes.
Yeah, it was a long time. But I will tell you guys, I did feel a little uncomfortable afterwards.
Why?
Because Kristian ran out so fast and said, no, we had just talked about my life, like all of these serious things. I felt very connected.
Thanks for the show.
I felt very connected, and he didn't even say that. We finished. He goes, what time is it? And I told him, and he just got up and left, and we did not speak another word.
He was late for a meeting.
I was 15 minutes
late. I literally was like, did I piss him off?
No, not at all. You were amazing.
Was it bad?
No, you were great.
He
said
he
was pissed off.
Yeah, that's not that was because yesterday I was supposed to have this meeting at 2. We finished at like 2:20.
Yeah.
And because it was so good, and I was so locked in, and I learned so much about you. I loved it. It was great. But
you did a great job with it.
But you do have a way. You have like a version something in between like Asperger's and ADD, where if you're
here
not
we go again, huh?
If you're not entertained by the country, you just walk away.
That's not true.
It's true.
It did feel like that's what happened. Like I had finished entertaining him, he was no longer interested in me, and bye.
Yeah,
but that's definitely not true. I was very interested in you, and I learned a lot about you.
It was like you were on fire. And then I saw you coming down to the bathroom, and I go, "Oh, you go to the bathroom?" Because the only thing I could think of saying, and really what I was trying to say was, "Are you mad at me for something?" And you go, "Yeah, I had to pee." And then you go into the meeting, and I was like. Yeah, that's cool, man.
That makes sense.
Usually
hey,
that
dummy.
Is why someone's in the bathroom.
I was late for that meeting. Wendy was nice enough. She had some lunch waiting for me. I grabbed it and I just hightailed it to the room. Mm-hmm. Had the meeting there. And yesterday was very busy. And I had got shit done. I still haven't paid my damn Amazon bill. And
what does that mean?
And they keep sending me notice. I got to pay my card. I haven't done it. I got to do it.
I Cyber Monday the hell out of the place yesterday. I got all of my Christmas shopping done in like an hour.
No way.
Damn,
yes.
Dude.
Everything.
See, my wife is so good at that right now. She's there's some, and that's the other thing. Yesterday, she's writing me. She's like, did you? That's what she texted me on the.
Did you get the sweatshirts?
I did. That's one of the things I had to do. It took me forever to finally do it, but by the end of the day, I did it.
What sweatshirts did you get?
Well, I got some. There was athletic ones for my niece.
Yeah.
There was some like my family Schmoedown fans.
You're getting all the Schmoedown sweatshirts.
Some of them. I'm gonna get some, cool. And then there's other things I want to do too. But I want to go back to saying I don't walk away from people.
Sometimes you do.
I never walked away from you.
It literally happened yesterday.
That's different.
Sometimes I'll be like. I'll be talking to you, and I know you're not paying attention. Like, there's not one bit of you that's paying attention.
That's not true.
And I could be like, you know, I could do the classic in a comedy thing, like, yeah, well, and then I walked off a cliff, and I found a bear, and me and the bear lived in the woods together. Like, cool, cool, cool. So if the wild berries want to play, cool. But
yes.
It's not all the time, but I can see, I've known you long enough to know.
If I'm locked in or not?
It's locked in.
Funny thing is, it's true.
Yeah, that's what you think. I'm always locked in. No. You should quiz me. Because I'm always locked in. I just might be thinking about a thousand different things.
Have you seen the GIF going around in the Schmoedown?
It's my favorite.
Of the Christian stare?
I approved it. Bring it up on the Movie Trivia Schmoedown on Facebook.
Fucking hysterical, and I'm using the F word. That's one.
I approved
because
it.
Because,
you know, here's, I'm going to explain this.
It's
because
so great.
Have
and
you
seen
Elvis
this yet?
Have you
seen
it? No,
it?
I haven't seen
Bring
it.
Up the Schmoedown group.
It's hysterical.
It's really good. So...
Now we got to sign into Facebook. Here's a question.
Look at Cody, just like confused, like doesn't know what to do. Just like sitting there, they're like they're in a dead sweat, panicking on how to log into Facebook back there.
Kristian,
that's not how you do. You know, just put my name in there, Cody. That's not You got to actually log in.
Here's a question for the room.
What's he writing now?
It's Alex. Okay. Alex.
Here's a question for the room. Yeah. If you get to like say an Amazon or a Facebook or whatever, and you have to sign in, and when you hit return, it doesn't autofill your password. Do you just give up? Because I don't even know half of my passwords.
People keep entire docs of this now. You make a Google Doc of all of your passwords.
I've got it written down and hidden in places just in case. Yeah. It's ridiculous. Hard.
You gotta go.
When my laptop got stolen last year, I had to reset everything.
That's the
talking
worst.
Every
that's
single stinks. Password.
Your laptop got stolen?
Yeah, from here, from the Collider office.
Yeah. Well, not,
do we know
not
who did it?
Yes.
The old one.
Not this
we
one.
We know who did it?
Yeah, we know.
We pretty much know, but they'll never get arrested.
What?
Yeah.
Wait, you're telling me at Collider you had your laptop stolen?
That was the least thing stolen. They stole everything. Camera.
Yeah, I don't know if we're about to really divulge.
Oh, we're not allowed to talk about that.
We've never really talked about it.
So. Oh, really?
There's a lot of stuff that happened.
Well, the cops aren't doing anything. So if you're out there and you robbed us, I'm coming for you. I'm bringing Matt Serra and a bat.
There it is.
Yeah, that would be good. Is this the phone number? Okay, yeah.
There it is.
Do I know the person?
There it is.
No, that's not it. You got to go to the actual video. Oh, yeah.
What's up?
No. So listen.
Oh, there's
so
that one.
There's that one
good.
Too. That's a good one.
Actually, that's probably your best Instagram post.
Well,
that's why
I did it. I was walking back from dropping my daughter off at school, and I was looking at it, and
look
I was like,
that
you know
lovely
what?
Smile.
I was like, you know what? I'm gonna smile, and then I was gonna caption it really nicely, and I was sucking Macuga. So keep going down. You got to find the actual video itself, but it's gonna have to scroll. Just let me know when you find it. When it was asked to be approved, because I approve a lot of these posts. And someone had captioned it out.
Is it a GIF?
No, it's a video. And so what happens is when Ellis reads the rules, we read the rules on the showdown every match.
Times.
It's for new people who are coming in and checking it out. And so I'm gone. Is this it? Yeah, watch. So he's telling the rules. I am.
Oh my God.
I am in another planet. He's reading the rules.
I spit out my coffee. I couldn't stop. You gotta remember.
I thought that the actual credits.
How many seconds is that?
That's so long.
I thought the credits were over. I thought that. I just go back to the very beginning.
It's
of that. Go back to the
seconds.
Beginning. Go back to the beginning of it. No, very beginning. Pause. Go beginning and pause it. You son of a bitch. Pause it in the very beginning of it. Like that. I thought that title screen was up over it. So I'm just like thinking, all right, what are we gonna do next? Here's the next couple things, and I'm on another planet at that point.
I mean, it means you trust Ellis. You need to listen.
To read the rules? You would hope so. This is match like 485.
Right. Sometimes Ellis will go like, welcome back to me. In the middle of the, but like is there any way to play music over that, guys? I don't know, because it's
This is
why I tell Snelling to suck it, because that is really funny.
That's pretty good.
And I'm on another planet as far as...
You're gone.
It's ridiculous.
I look
absolutely ridiculous.
And I've seen that look when I've talked to before. Come
you're
on.
You're telling me a story and I'm like that? Then yeah, there's no way.
From all three of us in the room, dear Kristian, there's a way.
Dude, okay.
See, your circumstances is different from what they're talking about.
Back in the day, and I think it was Toad Hop days.
Here, look.
Oh, perfect. Thank you.
You're even playing with your lips a little bit.
It's really good.
Oh, my God.
Rewind it. Just rewind it and do it again.
I can't.
It's really good. I don't even know what I'm thinking about. Oh, it's really good.
What are you doing with your mouth? Like
I don't know.
It's like
I don't know. And then I just come back. And it's like I got.
It's like something.
But I just come back. Watch. Just out of nowhere, I just come back. I'm gone. I don't know where I am. It's like I'm sleeping.
Look at that.
I'm sleeping.
That should be on one of those like YouTube bloopers.
That is the funniest thing.
It's really
good.
With
the music now?
It's really good. Like I'm telling you, when someone posted that in the group, I saw because I get to approve all the posts. And if I didn't take a piss at myself, I wouldn't have approved it.
Yeah.
And I looked at it and I was like, that's fucking funny. Oh my goodness. I have no idea where I'm at.
I needed that this morning. It's really good. I'm pretty hungover.
What match is that?
I don't know which match that was. I don't know.
Do you see the episode where Homer Simpson's is thinking about clown college?
It's that. I don't know where I am.
Maybe it's like Ellis is reading the rules and yeah. Kristian.
I'm waiting for Brian Ward to do a video of like the little bubble on the side and like there's just things like again there've been a tons of memes and should be. I mean it's so ridiculous.
Oh, my side hurts. So that's great.
Anybody who's listening needs to switch over to watch.
Yeah, just watch it.
I blame Aaron Wilhelm for that. Our editor. I blame Aaron Wilhelm. He should have ran those graphics a lot longer.
You know if you say you just said Aaron Wilhelm real fast and kind of sounded like you said marijuana. You're like Aaron Wilhelm.
Aaron Wilhelm. Oh, is that new? What is that from? It's the same. Is that a different
They're
one?
Moving your
that's
mouth.
A that's one. A different one. Perfect. Because those fucking credits. God damn you, Aaron. It's Aaron Wilhelm.
Well, you have a new place to put a note. If I'm on another planet,
good.
Please Dude, put a graphic over me.
It's really
that makes
good.
Me so happy.
All right. I want to do. Oh, so the other thing that we had. So there's some sound bites that Cody was playing before the show started. And there's some good ones. There's one that I know right away, but I want to play that game of see if people can guess who it is. So, Cody, play the first one.
Ugh. Sorry, one second.
Okay. I'm so bad at this.
All right, ready?
Okay.
You're such an idiot!
Oh, that's Roca.
Roca.
Yeah, I was good Roca. At that. I okay. got it.
All right, next
Suck
one.
Suck my balls, man.
That's Roca. Roca.
I know that. That's
right. Sensing the theme here.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, and...
Oh. Is that Roca?
No.
Ellis.
No. Oh. Who do you, I want to see if the audience can guess who this is. Your laptop open?
Yeah, I'll get it open.
All right, so let's see. One more time.
Oh.
All right, Roxy.
Snyder?
No.
I thought it was me, but it's not.
It's not you. Riley?
Oh. Oh. Brett?
No. You got
Is it me?
It's not you. Oh, yeah. Hey. I'm gonna let the audience listen to it one more time.
Oh. Oh.
All right.
All right, hold on. I'm letting the chat. Bibiani.
Yeah. It's not Bibiani.
Okay.
Is it a Schmoedown competitor?
Oh.
That's a no.
Kind of.
It's not Cal.
Ken?
Jay?
Nope.
Oh. Nost.
I'm gonna see if anybody else knows.
So I have Brett. Oh. Brett. Cody?
Nope. Nobody
Cobster.
Knows.
Cobster. Nope. Not Macuga.
No one's guessed.
Sam?
Nope.
It's not that.
Okay.
Oh, I guess that. I said that.
You said that.
Yeah. Oh. I said that also.
After like a little bit before.
Oh, nobody in the chat
said
got that.
Yeah, it's during the anarchy when they're picking out the things and he sees. Oh. I think
it was mine.
You know, it was Rooker Merle. I think.
Was it?
And he goes, "Oh, John is on." That was so funny. All right, you got another one for us?
I got one that's really quiet.
Okay. All right.
Oh, biscuits.
Oh, that's Copster, right?
That was Copster.
Oh, biscuits.
Is that Copster?
It was not.
No.
Oh.
Oh, biscuits.
Oh, that's Adam.
Adam.
There you go.
Yeah. If it's not Copster, it's Adam. Okay. So
biscuits.
Riley and I were on the phone last night. And I'm not gonna tell
FaceTime.
I was driving home and had the audio, but this is a story that I don't think I've ever told on the air that we said, well, I've got to.
Okay.
I won't mention names, but I was at this, I was at a friend's house and it was a gathering and we were playing like this game to where it was two teams against each other. And I think two teams of like seven or eight people on each team and you'd have to give clues, right? Of saying, okay, so she's married to Kevin Bacon, Kira Cedric, you know.
Yeah.
Whatever it might be. Okay. Just combining and you have to give clues to get there. And I forget what the actual game itself was, but you get the gist of it.
Totally.
So it goes to each person, they each give a clue until somebody gets
there's
it?
There's a team that's together. Okay. So each team got enough points, and we work in together. And if we were a team, Roxy, Josh would all work together to figure out clues that we all knew.
It's not heads up.
I don't remember. The importance is that it's just you had to work together for clues.
Okay.
So there was this mother and daughter there.
On your team?
On the opposite team. And they were pretty much like Jango Fett and Boba Fett. They looked like the older and younger version of each other.
In a good way?
Yeah. And so, but it's just, an older version and a younger version. And so the mother was talking and she's just. She's okay. Now listen. This next clue it's so simple. Everyone will get it. So it's like that time. You'll remember this, honey. what was the name of the horse that you had on the ranch? Come on, everybody. And this one guy, he looks up, he goes, and so they didn't get it. The time ran out. And the guy goes, I got to tell you, that was a pretty rotten clue for the rest of us. And I started crying laughing, and I told Reilly about it when it happened.
The word rotten's pretty good.
It's rotten, yeah, it's... And it was this dead pause to where she's like, right? And the guy looks at her and just goes, you know, I got to tell you. And it killed me. And then so Reilly and I started just using it. You know, it's like that. This is an easy one. This is even before you were born. You remember this. It's like that one time. That remember, what were we eating on the beach that day? Anybody? Anybody know?
Okay. I like that book. So
I mean,
and I know who he's talking referencing. So we started going back and forth. This thing could go on for hours.
Go on forever.
It's that show. It kind of sounds a little Adam Sandler.
But it's just it's and when you know the person. Medulla oblongata. But you just know. And she's like, okay.
What's the name of the horse?
So it's irrelevant.
God, I love you so much.
Okay, everybody, now listen. This is the one that you all got to get. Where did my father take me when I was six? And we were all going. I mean, everybody. If there was the easiest clue, this is the easiest
the
one.
The park?
No, no, come on. Now, I'm handing you this one to you. Now okay, how about this? This is the one time. What's the story my grandmother used to read all of us? And what was the meal we ate right afterwards?
Okay, this one's easy. Remember, what was the place your dad took me on the first movie we went on a date with? Yeah, everybody's seen that
everybody
movie.
Got
everybody
it. Seen Come it. On, everyone's got it. It's a rotten clue.
I like this voice. Can we name this person?
We can make. Let's call her. Let's call her Mrs. S.
Mrs. S.
Yeah, we'll call
Seabiscuit.
Her. Yeah, Mrs. Seabiscuit. No, Mrs. Sure. S. But anyways, oh, wait a minute. Before we go any further along, and I don't want to run out of the room afterwards, what happened? What's this Lyft story? What happened?
Oh, my Lord.
I was like, what did I do with the horse?
No, I hope nothing.
It was so wild.
Where were you last night, Roxy, when you were in? Now, remember, we talked about this.
Roxy, I got to listen to this story because it's very important. Everybody's got to listen to this.
So I was coming from dinner with our friend Sarah Stratton.
Yes.
And
oh, you know Sarah.
Stop, let her tell the story.
And I was lifting home. Mm-hmm. And I called a Lyft. I went out. I got in the car. They said, Roxanne. I said, yes. So I knew that. That's how you know that they're there for you.
Did she pull out the red light there?
Come on, let her tell the story.
Kind of. So I only live 6 minutes from where I was going to dinner.
Okay.
And 2 minutes down the road, we get pulled over.
Oh.
I've never been pulled over in a Lyft before. Right. So first of all, I don't realize what's going on because you guys know sometimes I'm in my own little world, and especially if I've had a couple drinks or whatever. So he pulls over. I go, I don't live here. He said, I know we're getting pulled over. And then bullshit. I like look up and I see the lights and I said, okay. So I sat there. I was very awkward. The officer came over. She was talking to him. And I just started responding because I don't know.
Why not?
Why not?
Can I come?
Can I? Exactly. But she says to him, do you know
why
I pulled
you
over?
Yeah. Mrs. S. And before you guys go any further, it was like when you're going to that deli. Do you remember the deli that we used to go to when you were six?
Roxanne? Windows.
Right, guys. So do you know why we pulled you over?
So
it was Jerry.
It was.
Point to you.
It was.
So do you know why I pulled you over? And he said, no. And she said, well, this car is not registered.
Oh, burn.
And he said, it is.
Oh.
And she said,
okay.
No,
it's actually not, sir. Can I have your license, please? And so he gives the license, and she goes to check it out. Now, you can tell this guy is too nervous for somebody who is going to be okay.
Yeah.
He's sitting there. He's sweating. He turns around and looks at me and says, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. And I was like, what is he so sorry for? Whatever.
Right.
She comes back over and says, you have a warrant out.
Oh, this is.
And I'm still in the back of the car.
Right.
Just, why?
You were Stratton or without?
No, I'm by myself.
Yourself. Okay.
And so,
you remember that time we had a warrant?
I know.
She says, you have a warrant out.
What?
And she says, do you know what it's for? And he says, yep.
Oh.
And she,
kidnapping.
And she says, okay. So you have a passenger right now. Where do you live? And I was like, down the street, but I can get out.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
She was like, no, I'm gonna let him drive you home.
I'm not gonna
arrest you today, sir. But the next person who pulls you over will. So take care of that.
Do you know what it was? No idea.
I have no idea.
What cop was this? Was this a play situation?
I have no idea. And she left. I kind of like looked at her like I was a little kid, and she was my mom walking right. away. Like, oh, why are you leaving you me leave here me? With this right. man?
There's so many things wrong with this.
Well, yeah, I know.
Must have been, but it must have not been. Maybe it must have been like a headlight gone out or something. You just didn't, or you know, whatever it was.
Unpaid parking.
Yeah. I have no idea, but they had some mutual understanding.
Right.
And so I literally had said, I can get out. So then she
Sounds
said
like
no.
An episode of Narcos.
She walks away. He rolls up my window.
Now you just can't leave.
And he turns to me and says, phew, you just saved my ass.
What'd you do?
I guess by being in there because he didn't get arrested. Right. And I said, okay. And he said, thanks. And I said, just get me home safe. I didn't know what I was supposed to do.
Do you do a rating at the end of that thing? Do you rate the Lyfts?
I haven't yet. I tweeted it out, and Lyft reached out to me last night and was like, hey, reach out to us if you want to further discuss your safety.
Yeah, give me $2,000 in free Lyfts or a full year of free Lyft. Because that's ridiculous.
Because Lyft,
or I'm going to talk about our live show.
Here we go.
Don't they have to prove registration? I'm guessing that kind of stuff?
I'm guessing they did, and then I'm guessing it's expired, right?
I guess.
So she let him
there's
go.
Once the training to be an Uber or Lyft driver, because I know a couple of them, is literally, do you have a license?
Yeah.
Great.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Here is your job.
It was so nerve wracking. I was tweeting in real time. So I started trying to take a video, but she did not like that because I was nervous.
Yeah.
And then I started tweeting in real time so that I'm documented while trying to also be funny, but like this is actually happening to me.
Right.
I still think that I was lucky, but I think I should have gotten out of the car.
Yeah,
but,
you probably should have.
Yeah, but I didn't know
Especially
how to do that.
After hearing all your stories yesterday,
You should get out of the car.
Yeah.
But I was like, I live literally 4 blocks away. I can just walk. And she was like, stay in the car, ma'am. And I was like, okay.
What the farts is going on?
Really she should like maybe offer to take me home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or follow you back.
And she did not. And he sped away so fast that I wanted to say, don't do that, bro.
Right.
Like, you'll get pulled over again.
Young guy, old guy?
Middle? Maybe 35.
Okay.
Maybe 35.
Doesn't know what he's doing with his life, basically.
Right. Yeah. And his English was very, very broken, so it was hard to communicate in general. But and I think she kind of just was like, I'm tired and I don't want to communicate with this.
I just don't want the paperwork.
Wow. Well,
getting too old for this.
Yeah.
All right, you need to stop doing things. Is what we realized.
Never leave the house.
Remember the Uber Lyft thing situation with you, Roxy? Because I was with Roxy. We got kicked out of this Uber because this guy was just a total
jackass. So I moved to Lyft. And
yeah.
Now look,
so you moved. Same thing.
Maybe go back to Uber. Why did I write something down about Creed? What were we going to talk about with Creed?
Did you go see it?
We're going to go see it.
No, I know we're going to go see it. But
tomorrow.
I said there's something about Creed.
It's good.
Was it about the director who was great?
Oh, no. I know what it is. No, that's not it. Which Creed is this in the franchise? No, Cody. The second one. Which Creed is this in the amount?
Creed 2.
What is it?
8th.
Is it the 8th?
8th.
Are you sure?
9?
No, I don't know if it's 9.
9th?
Yeah, it could be.
9.
No. Wait.
8th.
Yeah, that's possible.
8th.
Could be 8th.
8th.
Maybe. What was the other one?
9?
Yeah, it might be 9. You're right. We got to count it out.
9.
No, don't talk about it anymore. I just want to talk.
Christian, that is why you wrote down Creed?
Yes.
9?
That's why you wrote 9. Down Creed.
Because I said it says which Creed on my notes. And it also says Jason. Who's Jason?
Oh, you don't know who Jason, he's coming in later. So after Matt Serra, we've got Jason Aquaman coming in.
That's what
Jason Aquaman, attorney at law. He does all maritime laws. Hello, it's me, Jason Aquaman.
Oh, I remember this.
I represent people with boats, people who swam into boats, people with boats that aren't in water. As long as it's a maritime situation, were you robbed at a lake? I will represent you. I'm Jason Aquaman.
Mr. Aquaman, I have a question.
Okay.
I was recently riding in the boat, and I went under under a bridge.
What kind of boat was it?
It was a Duffy. And oh, I went
a slow boat.
Yeah, it's a low boat. Slow, very slow.
Yeah.
And I might have been drinking.
Okay.
And I was going under, and we thought we had it. But
what
no.
thought we had it?
Well, that we would, could go under the bridge.
Oh, okay.
Not so much. I ran under. It scratched the top.
Oh, we not the scratches.
Went, we kind of went sideways.
Yeah.
But then we pulled out. Somebody was there taking a picture of us. So
was anybody
all
injured?
Nobody was injured.
What yeah, happened to the boat?
Well, the boat has a lot of scratches, so I need an estimate.
Okay, call a Jason Aquaman. We'll represent you. No problem.
I just need an estimate. I
don't do that, but I have a guy.
Okay.
It's my brother, Dan Aquaman.
Okay, Dan Aquaman. What's the number?
1-800-555-TOOL.
Nice. Well, thank you. Thank you, Mr.
You're
Jason.
Well, thanks for having me on, Kristian.
Good to have you, Jason.
No problem.
We'll bring him back, too. That was
any
amazing.
Any relation to Phil Spiderman?
He's my cousin.
Oh, it's his cousin. Okay, good. Well, it's nice to have both those guys on the show, and I can't wait to see how their careers further.
Have you seen my other friend? He's in a movie.
You're cut off now.
Oh.
Let's get to the latest news in the movie world. We got some stuff.
You know, it's bombing when Roxy doesn't even acknowledge it.
I didn't think it was bombing. Here's the thing. So I'm very good at improv, despite you telling me that I'm bad, and I had nothing to add to that bit, so I let it play out.
Yeah.
That's a professional right there.
Here's what I was doing when I was listening to it, because I was not thinking about the video portion. I was thinking about the audio version. And I was like, if I'm listening to it on audio, I'm like, I like where this is going. What I liked about it was that when he would say, you're like, not the scratch.
What I wish was different, though. Yeah. I wish that there had been an injury.
Oh.
Because then I think we could have fun with that.
Got it.
You asked who was injured, but it was just the boat. But I wanted to know who was injured because then I want to see how you can help.
Yeah, okay.
Next time.
Nobody was injured, thankfully.
Yeah, that is.
That was a true story.
Oh, really?
Depending on what the movie does in the box office.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We went under... The thing,
well, then
the
I'm glad nobody was injured.
Yeah. Well, what we've learned is that both Jason Aquaman and Mrs. S. will return on future
shows.
Great.
That's great. Right.
Unless the audience tells us no.
You'll happening. Remember this one. Okay, I'm kidding.
Yeah, it's very simple. It's the best clue out of all.
What's your hat?
It's from Ripped Apparel, which we're not even with them anymore, but I just like the hat.
Oh. It's a great hat.
It's an old school. I used to wear it back on the
Toad Hop Days.
No, maybe towards the end of Toad Hop.
No, After Buzz.
After Buzz is really one.
First After Buzz.
Era. Five.
After Buzz 1.
Phase 5. All right, let's move on to some news. Anything happening in the world of news at all?
Yeah, it's been kind of slow, but this Guillermo del Toro kind of set the internet on fire because he put out there that he has a number, like we're talking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I mean so many scripts that haven't been, that went into development, he worked on for years, and they didn't. They didn't make it.
Could you pronounce his name correctly the next time you say it?
Guillermo del Toro?
Guillermo.
That's the great JTE. Guillermo. Can we find Guillermo? That sound clip somewhere, Cody?
Did you give him the point?
Well, no, because this wasn't during Schmoedown. This was like during Schmo's days, and he was just talking about him. If you go back into the Schmo's archives, JT's got some brilliant ones.
Oh, my God.
I mean,
would you
ones.
Give him that point today?
Guillermo? Probably not. Not.
He said Guillermo del Toro.
I mean, he spelled Geppetto is a great one.
Geppetto is so good. I was there for that.
But he did. Say, but that, we gave him that one because
he
phonetically, we knew where he was going.
Lena Headley.
That wasn't him. That wasn't him. Geppetto
is
a good one.
It is. Lena Headley, right?
Lena Headey.
No, it is. It's Headley, right?
It's Headey. Are you being serious? Are you being serious?
Riley thought I was for a second. He was like, no.
Okay. The actual phonetic.
But it is Headley, just to be clear, right? We're all on the same page.
The phonetic spelling
of Geppetto.
Of Geppetto, but also I'm looking in the mind of JTE, and there's like a teacher up there going, J.
Do you understand that teacher is drunk?
He's drunk.
It's like, okay, so the dinosaur. Yeah, the Trisanitarius toy stuffs. They're great. I mean, they go and they move around.
Has anybody seen my coffee?
Yeah, and they're going to do a movie with this Guillermo del Toro character. Say that.
I'm drunk. I pulled over. Call Phil.
In college, we have, in college at the fraternity, you have a chef that like cooks you lunch and dinner, right? It's that person, too, right? So we had this chalkboard, and she would write what was for lunch and what was for dinner. And so, like the second day, my sophomore year, we were having roast beef au jus, and she spelled it O-W-J-E-W.
Perfect.
Au jus. I'm like, all right, well.
So you take that, you take Al. Is he a Jew? I don't know. But he could be. He's a nice guy. I know him from the bagel store.
You sound like Carlin a little bit, man. I like it.
Yeah, that's kind of where was the idea was. Miss George.
Yeah. Well, what you do is.
He's the best.
More stuff.
Yeah. Great. The great George Carlin.
Yep.
I want to really see who's going to play him. Gotta say.
Michael Onganara. Ungarano.
Did he cast?
No, I mean, that's. Oh. I think. So he looks like him.
Here's the things that are wrong with the following statement.
check I miss him.
Before you check around your immediate seating area for anything you might have bought along. You know, first of all, let's start with immediate seating area. Seat. It's a goddamn seat. Check around your seat for any items you might have left on board.
I have a beef about
it. Well, I might have left my Arrowhead collection. I didn't, so I'm not going to look for it. It's the best.
A girl dropped a backpack on me
yesterday
while you were traveling coming home.
Is it the one? Is it the one that you took a picture of?
No.
Oh.
And it wasn't the girl that was picking her nose and eating it. She was.
Oh, let's talk about that afterwards.
Yeah.
No.
She was walking down the aisle with a guitar and hit like three people.
Airplane style.
Airplane, just like. Oh, whack, God. Whack. That was what was happening.
Yeah.
And she was she was clearly picking her nose and eating it because she was going like this.
Yeah. No, well, no.
Did you see the response?
No.
The guy said, well, if it's good enough for the Pope. Did you see that?
No.
Someone responded to your tweet of that one, and they had the picture of the Pope just going at it.
Really?
Oh, he digs in there and he eats it like a sandwich.
Stop. There's something that's
so gross about it.
It flips me. Picking your nose, I have no problem
but
with.
But eating it.
Eating it, there's something about it.
Yeah, they
that,
say it's nutritious.
I used to pick my nose and eat it when I was five. Yeah. There's something about that.
It's hard. It makes me want to vomit, to be honest.
Ooh, put it in the eggs. But yeah, that's gross.
It's disgusting.
Yeah, you have horrible plane trips.
This girl, so, you know, during holiday time, obviously, or whenever you're on a full flight, everybody's looking for that overhead compartment space, right? Yes. They're like fighting for it. And this girl jammed this book bag in it right above my seat, and I was like, I said to her, I was like, when you open this, when the plane, like, make sure you look at it, because she was sitting like four rows ahead of me. Make sure you look. And I'm not paying attention. She opens it. It lands right on my lap. Uh-oh. Thank God it didn't hit my weens.
Right.
But I looked at her and I go, what did I tell you?
You just said
like, I go, as a teacher. I was like, what did I tell you? And Amanda grabs me because I have two places where I get very angry. The car and the plane.
Right. Because you're confined.
Confined. Yeah. And people just.
There's germs everywhere.
Same.
So many people that just don't have common courtesy while traveling.
Or in movie theaters. It's the same thing. Yeah, it's the same animal.
You're right.
Yeah, people getting mad at you about cup holders and stuff.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Hey, you want to be a dick about it, then that's what you're going to get.
Have you ever been on a plane sitting in a window seat?
Oh.
Yes, I have. Sitting in a window seat and somebody gone like this, like tap to you and go, hey, lift up the window. I want to see out. Has anybody ever tapped
you? You know what? If you are in the window seat, it's your window.
Yeah. Correct. And I looked at her and said,
agree
no.
With you.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not, no. Yeah. That's not, you're not, this is for me.
There's a difference there. Again, this is goes back to what we talked about the other day with our conversation. There's a matter of how you address it and not the message behind it. Because that same person says to you, hey, I'm traveling. I've never really been able to see the city of the before. I'd love to get that view. Are you cool if you just lift it up? You'd be like, okay, cool. No problem. Lift it up. I want to see it. Go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
Go get me a soda.
No, and this move, this, hey, can you do that?
Yeah. I'm a
douchebag.
How about just the reach over and does it himself?
Oh, yeah.
You guys have had that before?
I've never had that, but I've seen it.
Yeah, I've sat in the window and a guy next to me reaches over, lifts the window. It's right over me.
Yeah, not.
It's
and then
excuse
you have to decide what kind of person am I going to be.
Right.
Do I put it down
or ask
and be clear,
right.
Or do I turn to him and have a conversation
about
it?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I think
I
you just shut it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I could see that.
If you're not going to ask me,
right.
I'm going to wait 1 minute and then I'm going to close it and you're going to get the message.
Just be polite.
It's my window.
That's it. Just be polite.
When we were going to New York a couple years ago for that complex holiday party, right? I'm getting on the flight and I have a window seat. I know that I do. And I get to my seat and there's a young girl and her dad is sitting in the aisle and the girl's in the window. And I was like, you know, I have the window seat. And the dad looks at me and he goes, do you want to keep it? And I go, yes, I want to keep it. It's a 6-hour flight. I want to sleep. Right. And he goes, okay. And he turns his daughter and goes, you can't have the window seat. And I was like, dude, really? Right now? That's what you're going
to
do?
But when it's, I don't understand. Didn't he want to sit next to his daughter?
That's what I'm saying. It's like, what, you want some stranger to sit in between you? No. You sit with your daughter on the other side. And I was also, I just eaten an edible. Remember he ate those edibles?
Yeah, I know. That was a great flight.
I was like, hey, man. Yeah, I was like, hey,
I'm on an edible. Leave me alone.
I don't want to be the jerk here, but I also, that's my seat.
And again, his etiquette is poor.
It's poor. It's bad. Look at this jerk taking your window seat, Claire.
But if he would have said to you, look, man, I really, my daughter, is it cool? She's one of her first. How old is the girl?
I don't know, 10?
Okay, she's not great on flights, really wants to be able to sit.
Here's what I say.
What grade is she
eighth.
In?
Eighth grade?
Well, what grade is she going into?
Nine.
In the ninth grade?
Ninth.
Better.
Okay.
No problem. I'll take the aisle. You sit next to your daughter in the middle, and I'll take the aisle.
If you ask, right. If you.
But I'm not taking the middle seat between you and your daughter.
Take the middle, because everyone knows the middle sucks.
Yeah. Middle sucks.
Yeah, the middle sucks. You got screwed with the middle. Deal with it.
Yeah.
That's what happens.
Sorry.
People are terrible sometimes. They really are. All right, let's move on to some other news.
News? Yeah, that was a good tangent, everyone. Well done. The Guillermo del Toro. Remember?
Oh,
he's doing these screenplays he wrote. Let me read them off real quick. The Witches, Justice League Dark, Beauty and the Beast, At the Mountains of Madness, Fantastic Voyage, The Count of Monte Cristo, Mephisto's Bridge, Pacific Rim 2, very different, he says. Secret Project Untitled.
We know what that is.
Yep.
What's that?
Superstitious.
One?
Nightmare Alley. Haunted Mansion. What?
You're
just going to drop? The Hulk Pilot. The Buried Giant. The Coffin. Drood. List of Seven.
Yeah.
I just think there were
a lot of rumors circulating around that. It was Star Wars. He was working on the Star Wars stuff. But I, whether or not we see it again, who the hell knows?
I'd like to see a Jabba the Hutt movie.
I think it was. I mean, that's again what he
picks his nose and eats it.
Yeah, he does.
Del Toro does?
Totally.
No, Jabba the Hutt.
Oh, Jabba the Hutt. Totally. 100%.
Yeah.
Totally.
Glad we're on the same page.
Yeah.
You think he can get his little hands up there to get his nose?
I think he probably uses his shoulder.
Salacious Crumb does it. Goes over there and does it for him. Yeah.
Because it's when Del Toro is one of my favorite people in this industry, but when you tweet that, you want people to ask questions.
Right.
You don't put, what's the secret project? Like, you'll never know. It's like, there was rumors like circulating a lot that he was really heavily involved with Star Wars, trying to get a Star Wars movie.
Have I told this on here before when I went to that Troll Hunters thing? It was him and Mark Hamill doing a Q&A. At DreamWorks and what he said about
Harvey Weinstein. That.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
So I went to see, it was Guillermo del Toro and Mark Hamill, and they took questions from the audience for like an hour. It was pretty amazing. And
what was this for?
Troll Hunters, the show on Netflix. And
Truffle Pumpers.
It's before Truffle Pumpers. Oh. There's. It was right around the time when Harvey Weinstein got in trouble and all that stuff was happening. And so somebody said, what's your horror stories in Hollywood? And he goes, well, I've written a lot of scripts that sit and turn around, and I spent 8 months working on a Harvey Weinstein, and I've never hated anyone in my life, and I hate that man, is what he said to a crowd of a lot of people.
Yeah.
Right? There was probably 300 people in the audience, and everybody starts just clapping. People that know. Yeah. And it was his honesty was awesome.
This is why I love him. He gives no Fs. No. And he's, again, met him. He's come into the studio before. Saw him again at the Critics' Choice Awards. Sweetest guy you will ever meet. Also, about as honest as they come.
Yep.
Another person that's very honest, and we're going to talk to Matt Serra about this. Dana White called in to his show, Matt Serra's show, UFC Unfiltered, and they were talking about, yesterday we brought it up, the Chuck Liddell, Tito Ortiz thing, and it's been a big thing inside of the MMA industry, obviously, and Dana White destroyed Oscar De La Hoya, called him a cokehead like a million times, called him Oscar De La Weirdo. What's up, Riley?
No,
you just heard it. So,
I've heard stories.
He was going off on him because basically Dana White and Chuck Liddell are very good friends. Dana White told Chuck Liddell 8 years ago, that's it, dude. You got to be done. But Chuck Liddell's a fighter and wanted to keep going. And the fact that California at all sanctioned the fight, he was like, that shocking enough. And the fact that De La Hoya was saying, this is what Dana White said, De La Hoya was pretty much saying, all these fighters, they don't get paid. You come with me, you get paid. He's like, five of the fights were amateur fights. He's like, nobody's getting paid. He goes, and he didn't know any of the names of any of the fighters on the damn show. He goes, and he messed up Liddell's name at the press conference. He goes, Oscar De La Hoya, give him like a pound of coke and tell him to get out of here. Like, he was going in on him. Like, wow. I knew, like, I couldn't believe how well he, you know, this is Dana White just kind of going off, and he's really passionate about it. But I was listening to that interview.
Is Tito Ortiz the dude's in prison that beat up Jenna Jameson?
Oh, I don't think he was he in prison? I know they were married. I don't know if they.
But didn't he get in trouble for like domestic abuse?
I don't know if he did. I know I think it was maybe I'm wrong. We should do so. I thought it was the opposite. I thought she
attacked him.
I thought so.
Can we
Google that? I don't know. But he Dana White didn't have kind words for Tito Ortiz either.
Right.
I said they belong in the same camp together. But it was. I encourage you guys to go listen to that. Not only was that particular interview on UFC Unfiltered really good. Jim Norton and Matt Serra talked to John Jones, who, you know, former UFC light heavyweight champion coming back, and that was a really good interview as well. It's an amazing show. It's a good show.
Can't
it's a UFC show.
MMA.
Never did, huh?
No. I mean, too. I like boxing. It just MMA just never. I just could never get into it. And I like Matt Serra, who's great on the show. Yeah. There's something about MMA that just doesn't equate with my brain. It's like wrestling, but I know.
I know what you mean.
I appreciate the athletes in the UFC way more than I would ever appreciate an athlete or a wrestler in, as far as what they get themselves
into.
You're
talking about sport-wise.
Sport-wise,
yeah,
correct.
Yeah. So let's see. You're right. He was. So Tito Ortiz was arrested for felony domestic violence at the home he shares with Jenna Jameson. This is 2010. Doesn't really say what. Doesn't say what they...
Says she had visible injuries.
Yeah. Yeah, so I don't know. Yeah, but that was like 10. That was like 8 years ago.
And it's not as bad as that other fighter that with
went to jail.
Yeah, he's in jail for life.
Who are you talking about?
What was his name? War Machine?
War Machine.
War Machine went to jail for life because he beat her up and didn't he kill somebody?
I think he raped her. And yeah, he beat her unconscious within inches of her life.
It was something. Yeah.
But there's a lot of fighters, right? Like, who was the one who fought earlier this year who was in jail for a long time for domestic violence?
A lot happens to a lot of boxers, for sure. And, you know, so MMA fighters as well.
Yeah, maybe it was a boxer.
I'm not sure.
I mean, you're brought up in violence. You're getting your head smashed in a lot. I mean, things get knocked around in there. And when you are prone to violence and you are encouraged to beat up people, it's hard. I'm not defending anybody like that, but it's not shocking
you
when these guys go
nuts. You could see why.
Correct. But here's the difference with that, is that the whole point of martial arts and mixed martial arts is to be able to contain that, what they teach you inside of martial arts. And you talk to someone like Matt Serra, right?
Yeah.
Matt Serra, bring up the video, actually, of Matt Serra at the airport. There was some guy, and I got to ask him about it when he calls in. So Matt Serra, controls drunk man because there's this guy watch this. Watch this. So Matt Serra just very calmly, like, yeah, this guy. Listen, this guy's hammered. And look at Serra.
Calm down. I'm going to break you. I'm going to fuck you up. It's okay.
Look at Serra just controlling him. He's like, take it easy.
Holy crap.
Yeah. He's just calm. He's not angry. He's just like, chill out, man.
That's amazing.
Yeah, look at him. Yeah, and he could kill this
guy. That guy's pretty ripped.
But he could kill this guy. He's like, chill out. He's like, you want to take over? Yeah. He's like, what do you want to do?
The security guy.
Yeah, he's like, no, I don't want to. Like how easy did, like, Serra?
What happened that Matt?
I don't know.
Sarah,
I don't know. I want to ask him about it.
This is an airport?
I don't know where it is. It seems like a scene. Yeah, so see, Sarah's just kind of just very chill about
the guy, I'm pressing charges. Yeah. Yeah. Sarah's like, ask anybody here.
And my point with that is he's the type. Matt Serra is a very different type of, it's more like a lot of the fighters.
Sure.
To where knows what he can do, doesn't use it to, he could have destroyed that guy and been the alpha and be like, look what you just got yourself into.
Right.
But he didn't. He said, calm down, buddy. He's like, relax. And he's just playing with the guy. And that's the type of thing that they teach you in jiu-jitsu and it's martial arts in general. And then you get these other people who use it. Look at, like, the force. It's the dark side users and the light side users.
Right.
And there's always people who are going to use it for the wrong. And there's people that do stuff like what happened. I don't know what happened with Tito Ortiz. And then
War Machine.
War Machine. Yeah. And then there's guys who use the discipline and you know, I think it's all walks of life.
Yeah. It's also comes along with football too. Mm-hmm. Is, you know, a lot of the amount of abuse that their bodies and brains take.
Yeah.
The CTE thing is like it changed the entire game and the entire way I look at football now.
Yes.
It's a lot harder to watch football now that I know what's happening. You know,
well, the XFL's coming out. You're going to be looking.
Can't wait.
Who's going to watch that?
Again? You're going to try it again?
No one's going to
watch it. It failed.
I would never bet against him.
I'm going to.
I'm betting against him.
I just would never
when
bet against him.
When it comes to this,
yeah,
do you know how expensive it is to run a sports franchise?
I'm not saying that I think it's necessarily going to be successful, but he's not somebody to bet against. I have no idea.
I'll tell you why I'm going to bet against him.
It already failed once.
I know.
Yeah, and we're talking about Vince McMahon. And I'm betting against Vince McMahon because this is something where his ego is letting it get the best of him because he cannot take that he failed that first time. It has eaten at him. And you have to respect that.
Yeah.
It has eaten at him. He wants to prove that he can make it work. I also think that what he was doing was he was, at the time of the announcement, right when all the Kaepernick thing was happening, and he was basically saying, we're going to put out a league and play into a lot of the people who were just like, oh, the NFL, similar to what you're talking about, in a different facet. But playing to that audience. But by the time that the league comes out, people are going to be moved on. So you're not going to take audience away from the NFL.
No way. You're just not
going to do it.
Not going to happen.
I think the biggest problem is that if he wanted to do something different, he'd have to have different rules about what players are allowed to do, like cannabis usage or whatever it is that makes players want to move over there that are not happy in the NFL, which he's not doing right now. But he's so smart.
It's going to be a B to C level product where, I mean, it's just going to be a lot of college guys that couldn't make it in the NFL or guys that aren't playing in the NFL or on scout teams, and that's what we're going to see, or guys that are retired that maybe want to come back and play a little bit. It's not a fun way to watch football because football, no matter what level you play at it, is every play is a chance at a horrific injury.
Or you're going to lose a lot of money because they're going to try to recruit people out of college, give them way more than they deserve,
and then fail
because they can't
sustain.
Same
thing happened in the USFL, same thing happened the first time in the XFL. It is really, really expensive to run a sports franchise in general, let alone a football franchise, which has the most players of any sport.
And NFL is just a juggernaut. And the thing is with Vince,
hear you guys. I don't know.
I get it. I understand. You look what he's done, how long he's sustained the WWE.
If he's going back at it, you don't think that he has some kind of greater plan.
He's got a plan, but this is a different thing. This isn't going to his business has always been, he grew up in the wrestling business. His dad ran wrestling and there's a different thing what he did. He took wrestling and flipped it on its head and did things. It used to be just very territorial, right? He made it national. He made it the whole one big thing.
You learn about it in the Andre the Giant documentary. It's pretty good.
And what he did. But that's the thing is that was his business. That's what he grew up in. He didn't grow up in football. He might know people inside of football, but that's not his business. Yeah. And also the other thing is, too, as much as I respect him and think what he did for wrestling in general, there's no one's going to do what he did for his business. He's out of touch when it comes to wrestling too. I went to SmackDown. I went to Raw. The product needs help. NXT, their other division that they run is run brilliantly, and it's run by Triple H. The day that Triple H gets a hold of the WWE, you're going to see a complete new shift in the way that company's run because I believe Vince is very out of touch with the way it is. He runs old school stuff, and he doesn't have any competition.
You have a monopoly basically.
He's got a monopoly, and he's got big competition in football.
Yeah.
And it's going to be
I can't fight for its success. I don't fight for its failure either.
No. I mean, look, if he flips it on its head and makes a new league than the NFL, I mean, then joke's on us. And then, 100%. Wow, look at that. Yeah. It's just he's just working. He's it's going
to
be tough.
There is a huge difference running 10 to 12 people in a ring.
Yeah.
Than 56 and an organization.
I would have to be a moron to not know that. Right. I agree. Of course.
And wrestling, though. Wrestling, when he, in 2000, when wrestling was at its peak with The Rock and Stone Cold, it's still big now, and they do really big numbers. But it's not in the front of pop culture the way it was when The Rock and Stone Cold and everybody were there. Through colleges and everything, too, it's certainly popular.
But there are more entertainment options.
There are. I mean, the reason for it, you know, it's irrelevant. But the point is that it's right now when they launched their first XFL game, they had the power of The Rock. They had Stone Cold. They had their first episode. Everybody was tuned into it. What's this going to be? How different is this going to be? And now it's just like, well, the excitement was there in 2000.
It's not there anymore.
It's more, there's a lot of skepticism.
But you also, dude, and I'm speaking as a diehard NFL fan. When the Super Bowl is over, I am NFL'd out. Yep. Like, I am exhausted by the whole thing. You need some NBA, some hockey, some, like, a breathing room to then get super excited for August for when training camp launches.
So when
are
they running the XFL?
It doesn't go on until 2020, but it's going to – basically the day after.
Oh, I thought it was the same
There's also going to be another football league called the AAF.
Who's doing that?
That's Charlie Ebersole, Dick Ebersole's son.
Right.
And that's going to be – that's tough too. But what they're doing, which they already have distribution. It's on CBS Sports, and you can live gamble during the show on the app while you're watching it. That's genius.
Look, go back – same thing with UFC, right? Yeah. UFC has competition.
Sure.
That legal?
Because sports gambling is legal federal now.
Yeah.
On the app, you can just do that.
Oh, as long as you have a setup account. I mean, I live bet during the weekend all the time.
Crazy.
Well, there you go.
It's 11. I'll fall in the hole.
So let's go to break because there's some more news that we'll talk about too. That was a good conversation. So when we get back, we'll talk about Aquaman, not Jason Aquaman. Aquaman. People saw the movie. There's reactions. We're going to talk about the reactions that we've heard thus far. And then we will we'll come back and we'll talk to Matt Serra as well at around 11:30. So come back with us. Glad to live. No, it's not late to the party. That's actually from Obi-Wan Kenobi. You didn't know that? Well, you should, and now you do. Jedi Council. What is it? It's about Star Wars, obviously. It's Jedi Council. Every week, the latest and greatest in Star Wars movie news, myself and Ken Knapsack, that's right, the pit boss himself, we have a guest on, and we talk about everything happening in the world of Star Wars. If it's the movie news, the TV news, canon news, comic books, games, and then we take questions from you guys on Facebook and Twitter. It's a lot of fun. We've been doing it for a couple of years now. I'm still excited talking about it. The fan base is coming together again. I believe it is. I think it is. I hope it is. And we're talking Star Wars, so we'd like you. That's right. All of you. If you're not a fan of Star Wars, come on over and join us every Thursday for Collider Jedi Council here on Collider Video. And we have an Apple Podcast feed or Podcast One, wherever you want to go if you listen to podcasts. And not only do you get Collider Jedi Council every week on Thursday, The Rule of Two with Mark Fernandez and Mark Reilly, that's on every week. I believe it drops on Wednesday. It's on one of these days. It's a good show. You should listen to it. I like it. I listen to it. I haven't listened to it once.
Hey, guys. Ryan Satin here from ProWrestlingSheet.com. And if you're a pro wrestling fan, which I hope you are, even if it's in secret, then you should be checking out Wrestling Sheet Radio Weekly. We've got a bunch of shows in the podcast feed. We've got weekly recaps for myself and John Rocha, which you guys will probably know from the Collider family. That's for Raw. That's for SmackDown. We've also got the weekly roundup of wrestling news. It's a show I host called Wrestling Sheet Radio with Jamie Iovine and Elijah Bates. And we've also got a bunch of other stuff in our YouTube channel, youtube.com/C/Wrestling Sheet. So check it out. Subscribe. And I hope you guys dig it.
Hey, everyone. Mark Ellis here. You know, when I'm not trying to clone dinosaurs or drinking at my neighborhood watering hole, I am probably hosting Collider Movie Talk. It's a flagship show here at Collider. I like to say that because I'm the host of it. It's every day, almost. It's 4 days a week, which is still pretty good, above 50%. You can watch it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. 4 p.m. Los Angeles time is when we do it. It's live, so you can participate in the live chat room. Go ahead and give us your thoughts on every story we have coming because it's all the latest movie news of the day. Who did what at the box office? What horrible Redbox movies Bruce Willis signed on to? The DC, the Marvel, the Star Warses, the Lord of the Rings. Are they making new? I think it's a TV show, and we still might talk about it anyway because we love movies around here. It's myself and an expert panel of guests, including John Rocha, Perry Nemiroff, Jeff Snyder, and other noted noters of note. You guys are going to love this show, and then we take your live Twitter questions at the end of the show at Collider Video. You can always use the hashtag Collider Movie Talk to get in touch with us, so subscribe right here to Collider Video. Check out Movie Talk, and check out the Collider Movie Talk podcast feed. We have a podcast feed now. You don't have to look at this handsomeness. You can just listen to it, whether you're driving to work, whether you're driving from work, or you don't have a job, but you have a basement and ears. years. You can listen to Collider Movie Talks feed. You can get it at Apple Podcasts or on iTunes. You also get Mailbag. That's the show that's hosted by Perry Nemiroff a lot more professionally than I run this pirate ship. That's our weekend show where she takes your letters. I don't know if you write them or you email them. You have to ask her. And Afterthoughts, hosted by Ryan Snelling and Jay Williams. I almost said Ryan Williams and Jay Snelling. Would anybody have known the difference? I certainly would. I would have felt bad about it because I'm a nice person, and that's why I host Collider Movie Talk. Check it out in video form or on our podcast feed.
What's up, Collider fans? If you are a fan of television and you want to watch a guy that looks like me and a guy named Thad Williams talk about TV every single Friday, subscribe to the Collider channel. Collider Podcast is where you can find the video. We have our own iTunes feed, hashtag at Collider TV Talk. You can find on iTunes or wherever you find your podcasts and you listen to them in your ear holes. That's where Collider TV Talk comes at you. We talk about TV news. We talk about shows we love, shows that we don't love. And most importantly, we don't read any books because TV has nothing to do with reading. We also have a show called Hypothetical Questions with myself and Roxy Striar and all kinds of reviews right here at the Collider Podcast channel and the Collider TV Talk feed. Subscribe, rate, like, tell your friends, tell all your friends to tell their friends. And before you know it's a pyramid scheme of television. I'm Josh Macuga. You can see Thad Williams and myself along with Roxy Striar and all the Collider personalities all the time right here on Collider TV Talk. As always, put down the book, pick up the remote.
Hey everyone, I'm Scott Movie Mance, and just to let you know, if you already don't, every Friday here on Collider Video, I host a weekly film review series called Movie Review Talk. The title says it all. Every week, I'm joined by two guest critics of my choice, and they're never the same. We review the new films. We pick something that's streaming that you might not know about, but is really great. And we pick a Blu-ray for something that you might have missed in theaters. It is fun. It is infectious. It is the Citizen Kane of movie review shows, and it's only right here on Collider with this guy, Scott Movie Mance, Mr. Movie Release Dates himself. Check it out every Friday at 10 a.m. Pacific, only on Collider Video.
Aquaman. Aquaman. I guess we're live, the door's still open. Riley hates closing the door.
Big time.
Why do you hate closing the door?
I walked in after him.
Oh. What? Your microphone's off. No one cares.
Yeah. Whatever. So that's
good. Oh, there it is. That smells fantastic. What is that?
Cinnamon raisin?
It's all in my mouth. I can't swallow it.
All right. Here we go. Collider Live. Welcome back, everybody.
Aquaman.
So we have... it's not Aquaman. You don't like it?
It's so much sugar on top.
It was a lot of sugar on top. I was walking out and I saw Roka had a cinnamon roll.
You look like you just ate like six lemons in a row.
No, lemon would be better. It's so sweet. And I like sweet things.
I like it.
Ooh, ooh.
You all right?
Ooh.
Take it.
Did we get that sound clip?
Ooh. Ooh. And everybody's going to guess it's a dude. Just me, Rox.
Quick shout out to Devon the Stewart. Bartender at this bar in Montrose. Thad and I went there last night. He came and was like, hey, big fan. Been watching you guys for a long, long time. Big Schmoedown fan. Big Collider fan. Really good guy. Gave us a shot. It was a lot of fun. I forget the name of the bar. God, it's an amazing dive bar.
Would you just wind up there randomly?
Yeah, well, Thad lives out there now.
Oh.
And so we went and had a drink. It's one of the best local bars I've ever been in, wow, in California. It's fantastic. Okay. It reminds me of the old St. Nick's, dude.
Oh, really?
Reminds me of the old St. Nick's.
When you guys point, are you directionally smart enough that you're pointing towards where Montrose just was when you just did that?
No.
He lives out there?
No, he's just pointing. Oh. He's Italian.
Everything's either up or over there.
Montrose is actually that way.
I never understand people like that.
All right, so I want to move on.
Is that way?
I want to move on for a second. And Riley told me during the break, very sad news today.
Yeah, sad news. SpongeBob SquarePants creator Steven Hillenburg died.
56?
57 years old. Suffered from ALS. So very sad.
What a sad. Yeah.
Thank you guys in the chat in particular pointed it out. I know a lot of you are fans. The SpongeBob missed me, but I of course know about the the great legacy now,
of course, yeah,
and the impact on
great
pop culture.
Song. One of the best theme songs of all time.
I've been trying to convince my little nieces and nephews to watch that show so I can watch it with them.
Right.
But they haven't gotten into it.
It's really good for multi-generational watching because there's different layers to it. And as a cannabis user, it has been a very... Amazing. Honestly, like I'm not even making a joke. I love watching SpongeBob.
One of the reasons it blew up as big as it did was because it was for kids, and then stoners in college loved
it. Because it was fun. It was funny. Cool. And they were interesting characters.
Both the movies. It was two movies? Or was there one movie? One movie, I think. And
the surfing one.
It was the live action one that they did. It was good. And I think that my daughter loves the theme song, but she's never watched the episodes.
But she knows the theme song.
She knows the theme
song.
Do they still make new episodes of the show, or is it...
That's a great question.
Well, there's another animated movie coming out.
Is it
like
live
next
action?
Year, I want to say? No, I think it's animated. Fully animated. Okay. Yeah.
Well, again, very sad disease. 57 is gone too young. But thank you
too. Because, like, I talk about it all the time. I love origin stories, right? The origin story of SpongeBob SquarePants. I mean, he had to be kind of high, right? I mean,
he was eating those burgers. All the Squidward was high of his gourd.
Squidward, but no, like the creator, that guy that created it was like, hey, what about a guy that's Sponge and his name is SpongeBob SquarePants?
Oh,
so like,
Stone
what?
Yeah, of course.
You know, it's
definitely. I think that was encouraged, and I think that's why people like it so much. It's kind of like Adventure Time. Like, that's what they're going for. Yeah, it's horrible, and I can't believe that in 2018 we do not have a better, not even just a cure, but a better thing for ALS for Lou Gehrig's. Like, it's just treatment. Yeah, it's oh gosh. If anybody who knows anybody who suffers with this, I just feel for you guys. It's one of the worst.
If you talk to I have a friend that's a cancer researcher, and he's like, dude, it's really hard.
Yeah.
It's really, really difficult.
And they all say, we're 10 years out. We're 10 years out.
Just keeps pushing.
We talked about that for a while.
10 years out. Yeah.
Again, thank you to the chat for informing us on the passing, and we prayers and thoughts go out to his family,
his friends,
fans, everyone. So once again, gone 57 years old. Oh,
57.
All right, let's move on to there's a lot of news that was coming out regarding Aquaman. I mean, the reactions came out and people went and saw it. Riley, what's it been? Mostly positive, mostly
seen
in the middle.
Lot,
what do you got?
A lot of positive.
Okay,
mostly positive. I mean, it's crazy positive.
Great. Yeah. I went by Roka and I said, "Are you still sticking to that $200 million opening weekend?"
What did he say?
What do you think he said?
No.
You think he said no? It's John Roka here we're talking about.
I think he said no.
I said yes. No, he can't.
He looked at me. I said, "You still sticking to it?" And he looks at me and goes,
"No."
And I go, "You're lying." He smiled. And it was basically, there's no way I'm sticking to
it. But they are saying right now they're projecting 100.
I think that's a lot more realistic than 200. Yeah. I'll tell you that.
Sorry, Riley, you have the information.
No, you're right. I'm just, 100 versus Bumblebee and Mary Poppins.
Well, but what I will say
Bumblebee,
is.
Didn't they?
All the same weekend.
Here's what I will say from a critic standpoint, which I hate that word, but whatever you want to call us. If Bumblebee was as strong as Aquaman was, then they wouldn't be saving
he
their press.
He's a giant robot.
They wouldn't be saving
Chomarone!
Their.
Chomarone!
Hey, come on, everybody.
I got a little chuckle out of it. Thanks. Their press screenings for so long. Like, the Aquaman embargo dropping as early as it did is a huge sign that it's great. I am seeing it this afternoon. I'm so excited for it. Everybody I know who's seen it has said really good things. If you're a non-industry professional, do you consider yourself an industry professional?
No. Neither one. You listen to any of these conversations that you guys have on the show?
I just think that Bumblebee right now, they haven't even set their screenings yet. That's...
Here's
coming up.
Here's the news about Bumblebee. They are
a tuna. Thank you, everybody.
Chamarone!
Jessica Simpson.
For one day only, next week, next Saturday, you can see Bumblebee early.
One day.
But that's you can go buy tickets, sure.
Okay,
but
so
I think they're making a play to spread that word. And so
for
that's
Aquaman,
what makes
you can
me
see
think
it
it's good.
Whole week early.
Sure.
But you're right. And the trailer makes me think it's good.
Yeah.
And Haley Steinfeld makes me think it's good. So I don't think it's not good. But when we were talking before about our rankings of things, I think Aquaman's going to be great.
Yeah.
Because why else would they be doing this?
I think everyone thought it was going to be good as
You've
far
seen
as quality.
It?
You know, I haven't seen it yet. But I think it's still box
office-wise.
Only
Dorian in the office, right?
Dorian is the only one. I like to bring when Matt Serra calls in. I like to bring Dorian in.
Yeah, Dorian's coming
SpongeBob SquarePants has seen it, too.
Snyder?
Frosty, you call it? Yeah. Nice. That's nice. You really are like that high school jock sometimes.
100%.
It's like, you know, it's the geek with the glasses. That guy.
Well, he almost spoiled it for the entire office
he
yesterday.
Did. That was a little bit.
I just turned around and go, Frosty, stop.
Yeah.
Because he was spoiling the
movie. He was going down.
Really?
And he was talking. And
he's like, I'm just giving details about certain plot points.
Finally, we were like, hey, whoa, come on, dude. You know, just, he's like, oh, I wasn't going to say anything. He's like,
You were.
I would have punched him in the face. Is he going to the junket?
Is he here?
Is Frosty here? Anybody?
Cody?
I didn't see
him. Isn't it weird that you have two people in your life named Frosty?
It is.
That's bizarre.
Is he out there?
I can't see him.
Neither are the snowmen.
Alex is too busy working on his band, which he's great at.
He's awesome.
He showed us this morning. I think he was just showing that to show the girl that he was kissing behind the curtain.
Do they ever actually kiss? I didn't see that part.
Yeah, they go at it.
Wow, and that was in 2014. Alex was 12.
Yeah, they're actually dating. Yeah. They've been
are they really?
Ever since that.
Are you lying? You're lying.
Wow,
Alex, who is that girl?
Hey, O'Brien.
She knew you'd get me, but you, wow.
Yeah, I know.
Gullible
question. I met her that day.
Whoa. Oh, look at George Clooney over here.
Yeah, old sultry Mardonia over there.
Was she a good kisser, Alex?
I met her. Yeah, you know, Rox, let me tell you about my situation. You know, I was singing on stage, and I saw the girl, and I said, come here, baby. It's day number one. It ain't going to be a day number two.
This is an easy one. We met on the stage behind the set.
Listen, I want you to tell everybody about...
You were singing that song that we were all talking about when you were born the day.
That's exactly right. Alex, tell us everyone. Everyone's going to get this. Alex, tell us. Everyone will know. What was the girl's name, her friend's name, that told you that she would be available for a nice chicken dinner later that night?
Chelsea,
thank you. Yay, I got a point. That's Chelsea, a point. Chelsea. But yeah, did you ever talk to Chelsea ever again after that?
Nope, okay. She was there for that one day.
All right.
Well, oh man, Alex, heartbreaker.
Yeah.
Heartbreaker.
Nice. Okay.
Wow.
But anyway, let's go back to the
Aquaman.
Aquaman. Tell me about the tweets. Tell me about some of the tweets.
Some of the tweets. We got some very good ones here. Brandon Davis, Aquaman is great. James Wan made a really unique superhero origin film, often crossing into fantasy epic territory, but grounded in family and discovery. The world is visually incredible. Jason Momoa as Arthur Curry is a total badass. Jermaine Lucier.
We already knew that.
I know Jermaine.
Yeah, Jermaine, friend of the show. Aquaman is a big, fun, wild ride. It's unabashedly melodramatic and over the top with the largest, most ambitious sense of scale imaginable. Parts of it are kind of bad, but they are not the majority and oddly still fit in with the cartoony tone, second best DCEU movie. Yeah.
It doesn't get me too encouraged.
I wasn't encouraged by that.
I didn't like parts of it are kind of bad. That's not what you're looking for.
I also like...
How's your wife? She's good most of the time. Other times, ugh.
I found a tweet that I thought was interesting. I'm going to pull it up. I'm letting you know that I'm doing that.
Right? I mean, it's legitimately the tweet.
Jermaine is a friend, and we talk, he's a big New York sports fan as well, too, and we always kind of shoot the crap. We're not normally on the same page when it comes to movies.
Okay.
So, because, I mean, we both went to the solo... premiere. I don't know if he's seen it since and changed his tune, but the day that he saw it, he loved it. He was like, you didn't like it? I was like,
I can't wait until that comes out on TV. I'm so excited.
Solo?
Yeah.
I have it. You just want a copy of it?
No. I want to like record it on my DVR. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, I want to keep so I can just like flip it on. This is like one of my favorite Star Wars movies.
You can do the same thing on the Blu-ray. I have an extra copy as well.
I don't have a Blu-ray player.
Well, then that's on you.
Can I have it?
No.
What's the deal with the Green Book?
Yeah.
We have a whole line. And then after him is him and then me, but in the office only.
Move on.
So. Yeah.
I have a tweet that I thought was interesting. Do you
care
if I...
No.
I'm curious what you guys make of this. This is from Paul Shirley, who said, I'll take some heat for this, but hashtag Aquaman is the best Marvel movie that DC has made. That doesn't mean it's exactly like that formula, but it feels like a film that knows what it is, what it's selling, and who it's selling to. There's no identity crisis here.
I love that tweet. Here's the thing. The reason why he knew he was going to take heat from it. Who wrote the tweet?
Paul Shirley.
Now, the reason why he knew it was going to take heat is because DC fans will get upset because they're like, why do you got to say it's a Marvel film? It's the point of the structure itself is that it stands alone. I don't necessarily think he needed to say that, but I think he got his point across by saying it. That to me is an encouraging tweet. Mm-hmm. That to me is like I already want to see this movie. I'm more encouraged to see it after that. So
the tweet that said that there are some bad parts didn't get you.
No, because again, I'm normally not Jermaine. Maybe it's the parts that we're, again I like
parts.
Him, but we just very different movie opinions.
Some
very
bad parts.
Different.
So, yeah. I mean, what was it good?
Yeah. Right.
Were there bad parts? Yeah.
It'd be terrible. All right. Anything else? Any other?
There's a lot. I mean, I don't know how many you want. Jenna Bush is a friend of the show. Aquaman was an absolute blast, from the charm of Momoa's Arthur Curry to the spectacular visuals to the fun that it was clear that everybody was having. It was exactly what I was hoping for, and I can't wait to see it again. Right. I'll give you more details when I'm allowed.
All right.
Yeah.
Dorian.
Speaking of which, yeah. I told you about Ben Meckler. And his tweets.
You told me off air. Tell the nice people at home.
Okay, so Ben Meckler is
who's Ben Meckler?
Noted as a writer, director, good boy.
of a thing called Good Boy, or he is a good boy.
Yeah, he's like, he wrote a good boy. Like,
which one's a good boy? Is that the Steve Carell movie?
Did you wish you wouldn't have said that?
I'm just reading his bio. Maybe he's
cannonball.
Yeah. Anyways,
I feel like I can see Cody every time he hits one. He just like a little muffin.
That's back. Well, that's absolutely
it's the one with the British dude.
Cody, show the crowd, and I'll go back. What your face is like after you hit the buttons of each sound bite.
Okay. Cannonball.
And then we'll go back and watch Cody laughing maniacally. All right, what's next?
Okay. No, do you want me to read the tweet from Ben?
I would love that.
Okay, good. I'm glad.
I would actually like it, Riley.
Here's the thing, guys.
I would fucking love it.
That's one.
That's one. Sorry.
Let me cue this up real quick.
Please.
Nothing like a hot Ben Meckler take.
We're
really waiting for this one.
This tweet has been now posted everywhere across all social media.
Good old it was Benny
retweeted.
Max.
It was retweeted by James
Holy
Vaughn.
Shit.
It was put up on all the... Just let me read the reaction.
I want to kill them for you.
I know.
I'm with you.
Reminds me when I grew up with my cousins.
Sleep in the hallway.
You know?
I love Ben Meckler so much. He's my favorite tweeter in Twitterverse.
I mean, they retweeted this thing.
That fucking retweet.
I know, Macuga. You are going to love this. If I can just fucking get it out.
That's one. That is actually two.
You know?
It's like so hard because Riley's 100% doing his job. And then you guys.
You're not calling old Benny Max over here doing my job?
We need a shirt. Benny Max. I'm a mech. Are you?
Mech.
Are you a Benny Mech?
Oh.
Wait, like that one time Benny Mech
did. Somebody's going to tweet this at Benny Mac. Oh, how's he going to feel?
He's already getting all this. Listen.
Fish splash, I was taking the bait.
All right. No sense.
All right. Okay. Now, mind you, everybody's retweeted this, put it all over the place. Aquaman, the official account, reached out to him, said, can we use this in our marketing campaign?
They did the same thing to Dorian.
He wrote this.
No, listen.
Aquaman is everything DC fans have been hoping for and more. Rollicking action, an amazing sense of world building, spellbinding musical numbers in which Aquaman wears clams, his tap shoes, and a command performance from Jason Momoa. DC has really righted the ship. The DCU lives. He follows up this tweet with Aquaman, James Wan has crafted a world like which we've never seen on screen before. It truly is an undersea Star Wars with a palpable sense of history. Hammerhead sharks with human legs who can pop, lock, and drop it. Flat out incredible creature design. Do you hear what he's doing?
He's becoming a Benny Max fan.
He is
destroying.
Just a little bit, like one
nonsense.
Sentence
it's
in
like
the middle.
It's like Dagnino tweeter.
Yes. Does Aquaman tie into the larger DCU? Hard to say. Little mention of the world outside of Atlantis, for better or for worse. But what I know is it'll be a long time before I forget Volkel's lyrical dance interpretation of Arthur Curry's conception. Best superhero film since Dark Knight. People are retweeting this
not realizing
because he is
round of applause.
Or realizing.
Or
I think they probably realize it. I mean, it's so.
No,
there's
no way.
There's a mixture of both.
I think there's a mixture of both, but. The ones that crack me up is that he's retweeting the ones, all of like the superhero.coms and all these websites. Collider didn't fall for it, thankfully, because I would have said something. But
pop,
that they're putting this
it.
On there. They're putting this
in
the
reactions.
I like
the clam tap shoes.
Me
too. The clam tap shoes.
You're being serious that DC official count retweeted that and Aquaman official count retweeted that?
Because
if that's true,
yes. Really? Yes, they.
As my
James
people
Wan,
say, it like
James
that.
Hold on, let me find the actual tweet.
Yeah, but I think he gets it.
Maybe.
He screenshotted James Wan retweeting both of those tweets. He did.
Love it.
He did, I never, he quote tweeted this, never signed a contract this fast in my entire life. Aquaman movie reached out and says, thanks for tweeting all about Aquaman movie. We'd like to use your tweet in the future. Please sign here. And he said, I've never signed a contract so fast
Benny
in my
Mac's
entire life.
Crushing
wow.
it.
Yeah, crushing it's it. Really good. That was good. Yeah. That was good. Yeah. All right, let's,
also,
what I'm going to do is.
Also,
he's
got to let them know.
This is the funny part of stuff.
This is like watching the firecrackers yeah. all over again.
I'm going to ask Matt Serra to call in now.
Okay.
We're going to talk to him about some stuff. And
do you know who represented Matt Serra all through his career?
Benny Max.
No, Jason Aquaman.
Jason Aquaman did.
Yeah.
Oh,
good. You know, Matt Serra, big boat guy. Maritimer.
I don't think that's true.
Oh.
Yeah. But I
see
have...
that was not good improv.
No.
Yes and
I don't think it's true.
Yes no. and
but I don't think it's true.
Well, then you put a halt.
All right. We're gonna do Cody, let me know. Halt. Let me know if we get the phone call because he's writing me back here. So
where did he text you? Read the text out loud.
First one was great. Second one is yes. Okay.
What do you think he means by that?
Yes and
yes, he's gonna call.
Yes and great
and
yeah.
Who?
All right. What? So Matt Serra will be calling in momentarily here, and we'll talk to Matt. Ask him a bunch of different things here too.
Splash, I was taking a bath.
It was
now
good.
In my head.
It was really good.
Really got
you
me.
Know. You know what's? It's been in my head for the last couple of days.
Splish, splash. I was taking a bath.
Yeah, but here's the problem with that. It's not. It's not Bobby that I'm hearing. I hear Elmo.
Oh yeah.
I hear Elmo.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
But the other thing, by the way, Basho. Remember I showed you that Basho. Cody says the number isn't working. Is that the right number?
Stand by.
Macuga, take over for a second.
Okay, so here's the story.
Tell me about Basho.
Okay, I don't know who Basho is, but I do know that Aquaman was my favorite superhero growing up because I was swimmer in high school, no big deal. And
you got the shoulders.
I had the swimmer shoulders, and I
Riley.
Loved Aquaman, because I always wanted to be like an underwater superhero. Not so much the talking to the fishes kind of a situation, I liked Aquaman. Now, my dad, who's like one of those comic book purists from back in the day, he's like, I'll watch this trailer for Aquaman. And he doesn't look like the Aquaman. It's like, not my Aquaman, right? Which is, I think that a lot of those old school guys, like my dad, who probably had Aquaman 1 at one point, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Kristen's waiting for you to finish. He's doing the face.
No,
sees these trailers and is like, I don't know. So because I was with them all this past weekend, and the Aquaman trailer was played a bunch of times. Yep, there
you got
it is.
You gave it to
him? Yeah, the one number off. So.
Okay. And
we're good.
Okay. Oh, you're a number off.
So I think that may hurt the box office when it comes to, you know, like my dad. When my dad sees a trailer for Captain America or when he sees Avengers, he is at the theater.
Well, is your dad on Twitter? Like, would these reactions help or hurt him?
It's my dad on Twitter. My dad communicates in emojis. That's basically
That's
what we have.
I've turned into not emojis, but the GIFs.
Oh, you love the GIFs.
I
yeah,
love
me too.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Did you guys see the picture that my dad texted me of me last night?
How would I?
Wait,
Mrs. S?
Yeah.
Hey, guys. Everyone must have seen this. Last night at 11 o'clock, I got a text. Didn't everyone else see that?
I Instagram storied it.
Kristian,
you have to post this along with the interview you did of me for one-on-one because it literally embodies everything that I was saying.
Okay.
I'm only talking about dad sending things. He said nothing else. He just sent me this picture. If you go
This is who we were talking about.
This is 2008
yesterday?
Roxy Striar.
Oh my god!
At Roxy Striar, you found on my Instagram.
Real teen angsty.
That is what.
That is everyone. That is everyone.
That's all he sent me.
Wow.
No words. Nope. Just this picture.
No, hey, I found this picture. Rox bum.
Yeah.
You're adorable.
Was that
like right after
a
summer
big
camp?
Big happy camper.
Wait, I guess he's on. Okay. So guys, joining us on the line, he is the former UFC welterweight champion, overall badass, Mr. Matt Serra. What's up, Matt? How you doing?
Thank you so much.
Don't go to a restaurant.
Oh, yeah. Well, hey, listen, I have a question for you that I wanted to ask you last time, and I never got a chance to do it, because we were talking about, you know, just MMA in general, and then just talking about how martial arts, I think I told you this when we talked, my daughter's in karate right now. She's 7, and she's taking karate and learning discipline.
That's a boy's toy.
Right. And so I had seen this video to where you kind of just subdued this dude who was I don't know, he was hammered or what was going on. And I was like, you could just see, obviously you could have crushed this guy's throat if you wanted to, but you're just kind of holding him back and just waiting until people got him out of there. What, where was that? What happened in that situation?
Oh, man, we didn't talk about that?
That's I don't think
crazy.
So. No.
We did. Oh, man. Well, I got the memory of a freaking goldfish, you know this. and by the way, before I get off the phone, we'll talk about this, but, dude, man, you guys, I don't know if you talked about, did you guys... Do you guys like the show Titans or no?
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna talk to you about that.
Right, well, I know. I don't want to get off the subject. We'll talk about me being a real life superhero in 1 second. But, dude, okay, I know. We'll talk about that first. Okay. No, listen. That was July. That was July 4th. That just passed.
Oh,
that
wow.
was at the Red Rock Casino. Yeah, that was at the Red Rock Casino in Vegas. And the next day, I was getting inducted into the I'm not doing this to brag. It's just funny the way things work out. The next day, I was getting inducted into the UFC Hall of Fame, right? So it's 4th of July, and my wife's there. I got my three little girls there that are 9, 7, and 5. My sister's there with her kid who's 20. And they wanted to go see some fireworks down the strip. I go, look, I'm in Vegas. I'm getting inducted tomorrow. I don't want to be around a bunch of drunks and stuff over in the strip, and it could be trouble. Let's just kind of be low key. And I don't know if you ever been to the Red Rock in that casino in that resort in Vegas. It's like a half an hour from the strip.
Okay.
It's really nice, man. It's really the Fatita brothers own it. The guys
own
the UFC.
Of course.
Beautiful, beautiful spot. You know, laid back. So we're at the cafe, and sure enough, a drunk couple comes in, and they're just. Done. I mean, done. So if you look on my Instagram, it's funny, Kristian. The one I put a video before that, and I was calling it like Weekend at Bernie's because the dude's propping her up and putting a hat on her. Oh, it's fucking amazing.
Yeah.
So I'm laughing at this. So then, fast forward, she's passed out. The guy takes off, comes back, and this guy is just the worst type of guy, the worst kind of truck you've seen. Just yelling shit, throwing things. Yelling for the waiters. The waiter's coming up. He's getting out. He's clenching his fists. And you know what, man? I just was like, yo, this. And you know, it's all quiet around the restaurant, like the cafe, because you know something's gonna, either security's gonna bounce him out in any second, or the guy's gonna do something. And it just was looking like an ugly scene. So I was almost out of there, man. My check was coming to the table, and he got up and intercepted my waiter, and was threatening him. So when I stood up. He directed that shit towards me. I'm sorry. I can curse the
name. Yeah.
Okay, good. So he directed that shit towards me. And, you know, I'm there with my wife and my kids. Now, you know, listen, I'm not bragging, but I can handle myself. And there's several ways I can neutralize that, you know. You know, I got my hands by knocking out, you know, some dangerous people, a dangerous person. So, like, I know I can hit him with a right hand. That's going to scar my kids. I hit him. His head hits the floor. I'm in trouble. When you have Brazilian jiu-jitsu, when you're a black belt in jiu-jitsu, not even a black belt, blue belt, purple belt, when you know Brazilian jiu-jitsu, and this is the right place to say it, you it's like having a superpower.
Right.
And I'm not even trying to be corny with that. Like, it's just, I've been on the mats, like jiu-jitsu mats, for 20 years. I mean, I've been rolling around. I know, and that's what, and I know, I've been rolling day in and day out with guys that know what they're doing, guys that know how to escape submission holds, guys that know how to put on submission holds, guys that know how to escape bad positions. So I knew that if I get my hands on this guy, I'm just going to, you know, I didn't think there's much he could do.
No.
So when the guy, I just took him down because the guy went to, when I squared up with him, the guy went to, you know, I when I got up, the guy dressed everything towards me. He took his shirt off and then I just got him right around the waist, put him down. I told my sister to film it. Because, listen, man, where I come, you know, the deal, you're from the East Coast. I'm sure it goes around all over. The winner goes to the loser goes to the hospital. The winner goes to jail.
Yep.
That's six pressing charges. So I was like, yo, man, I don't want to get charges pressed against me. So my sister ended up filming it. That shit went viral, Chris.
Oh, yeah,
man,
I
was on TMZ. Yeah, that was insane. And it wasn't bad for my jiu-jitsu schools here on Long Island.
Well, no, but that's what I was saying to the guys. You equated a superpower. I said it's like you could use it for the light side of the force or the dark side of the force, right? And like you,
100%.
Obviously, use it for the light side because you were like you said, you could have really done damage to that guy. But instead, it's like, come on, buddy, cut it out, you know. And that almost is a little more.
Yeah.
Well, it's like when you're when you're fighting with your brother when you're a kid. I had a brother who's 3 years older than me, and when he hit his growth spurt way before I did, and he'd just be like, stop it, and he's like, he pinned my ass.
Why are you hitting yourself? Why are you hitting yourself?
Matt, did he know who you were? Did he have any idea?
No, I don't. I don't think that dude knew who he was at that point.
Right. Well, he doesn't.
He was out of his mind. No, that guy was real trash. Yeah. I don't know who he was. I sent it to. I didn't expect that thing to go viral. I was just trying to protect my ass, you know. Yeah. And, you know, my kids were there. At one point, though, hey, Kristian, I'll tell you, because I was telling him, calm down. But at one point, I looked up and I locked eyes with my 7-year-old girl, my daughter Maria. And, you know, she's just looking like, look at me, like a bird that fell out of a nest. Like, yeah. Just looking at me. So I look up at her and I'm like, it's okay. And so my voice gets really like, daddy, okay. And then I go back to, you know, just controlling that
idiot. Dude, it was great.
But you know what's even worse than that idiot? The fat security guy that comes over.
Right.
Oh, you secure? He's like, oh, you want, I don't know if you've seen that. He said, oh, you said doing them? I'm like, yeah. I go, you want to take over?
I did see that. It was all right. Great.
He told me just to get off him. I'm like, hey, dude, you want to wait? I have this on the show. Do you want to wait till you have some more buddies over or something? Like, when if I go to let go of him, there's going to be a little lapse in time where, nobody's controlling him.
No, dude, it was great. Like, it was so good because you could tell inside of the clip, like after you let go, it was you can tell that dude is a professional fighter because you step back and you move back, and it's just like you're ready for the next attack if it was going to come. But anyway, I wanted to ask you about that last time, and I just totally forgot about it. Now I do have
no problem, man. I thought you were going to bring up the Star Wars movies that I didn't get to.
No.
If I like the new ones. And I'm so old, I'm like, oh, you mean the prequels? Oh, man, I didn't mean that shit. Well, I love that new shit.
There's tons of it.
Hey, listen, Force Awakens, money. Money! I love it. Dude, there's parts in that movie. I mean, Last Jedi, I don't want to ship anybody's fucking cigar. I don't want to shit anybody's cereal, but oh, my God. But listen, hold on. The Force Awakens.
Paid by Disney.
There's parts in that movie. I look at I like to be moved, man. First of all, I loved catching up with Han and Chewie and the fuck. I love that shit. And he said, I just love all that. I can watch that. That was beautiful, you know?
Yeah.
And really quick, just a part that stands out. When what's his name? The fucking, I'm sorry, dude.
Kylo Ren?
Yes, of course. Shame on me. I'm not even on the Jedi Council before I'm off the Jedi Council. Fucking with Kylo. And when he was looking for that, when he was going to get that lightsaber and It went past him and it went right to Ray's hand and the music went on.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, of course.
Holy shit, man, my nipples got hard. I loved it. The music went on. I go, boom, I'm back to my childhood.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
I think so, too.
That was amazing.
I think that's what we're going to see a lot of in Episode 9. I think Episode 9 is going to show a lot of that, and I think JJ is going to do... Riley actually and I talked about that a lot yesterday on Rule of Two. But yeah, man, there's so much I want to talk to you about because the funny thing is, you told me, I listened to your episode of UFC Unfiltered this morning on the way into work and great.
Oh, did you hear that, buddy?
Hey, listen,
would it have been odd if I texted you on a Sunday?
No, and you know what's so funny, dude, you know what's so funny about that is that I literally had I had the same conversation with my wife like last night. I said to her, I was like, before I listened to the show, I said to my wife last night, I go, you gotta admit, it's pretty fucking cool that I text back and forth with Matt Serra. And she's like, I know, you're very excited about that. And then I heard that this morning.
That's funny.
Yeah, I was like, yeah, you should absolutely, you can always give me a text. But I was listening to that episode. I listened to the full thing. Yeah. The John Jones interview was amazing. But I gotta tell you, the thing that stood out to me was Dana White coming in hot.
Oh my God! Did you hear that, man?
Yeah,
man,
he went.
Oscar De La Hoya, go get. That was insane, dude. I wasn't there for that. Pulled in. You know, I live in Long Island, so I left the studio. I got back on the train, and they go, "Yo, Dana's calling in." So I missed it. So Jimmy just took that by himself,
dude. It was
pretty sick, man. If anybody wants to listen to that on UFC Unfiltered, Give that a shot.
We talk about
geeky shit on there too.
I know. Well, that's funny because I've heard the times that you've mentioned this show, obviously, and then you'd said, and this is kind of an ongoing joke now on this show, is that you say to Jimmy, you're like, I talk about that Collider Live all the time. He goes, yeah, absolutely. Roxy Striar did a show with him last week.
I co-hosted Jim and Sam all week with them. I asked him many times about it. Yeah, no idea.
What?
Yeah. So she goes. She's like, Jimmy. She's like, Jim. So Collider Live. He goes, I don't know what you're talking about.
No, you gotta just tell them. You tell them the stuff that I'm into.
I was like, that geeky stuff your friend Matt's into, and he was like, Yeah, I don't know.
He's like, I love Matt Serra.
Yeah, I was like, I love Matt Serra.
Don't know what you're talking about.
He was like, yeah, I love him too. I don't know the show you're talking about.
It was really funny. And you can also tell him I did not get blown on Sunday, but I'll make sure the next Sunday turns
out. Dude, how great was that? Does the rest of the crew know what you're talking about?
Yeah. I told him.
No, because listen, man, let's get into that DC app, right? Because I asked you guys about that, and I'm pretty sure I got counseled against it.
No. They're a sponsor of the show.
DC, oh, they are?
Yeah, and remember...
Dude, shame on me.
That's all right. You know, and I'm shocked that they should sponsor your show. But the other thing that is funny about that, because we'll talk about this after you talk about the DC app that I told you about, the movie Trivia Schmoedown and all that stuff. A lot of our people who are in that show are actually on that DC app as well, hosting a show. Like my friend Tiffany Smith, Sam Levine, Clark Wolf. You'll see that when you, because you're really diving into that DC app, you'll see that show with a lot of
our friends.
Hector Navarro. But please, go ahead. Tell us about Titans.
Oh, well, listen, man. I was blown away. And I'm not a Teen Titans guy. I know that there's that cartoon that's cute and everything. And like, I took my kids to see that movie, and there's some funny jokes. And I'm just not – it's just not my thing, though. You know, right. I mean, it's not that I grew up with and whatever. But I always thought they were cool. I always liked Nightwing. I liked that Dick Grayson and how he became Nightwing and all that kind of thing. But again, you know, I grew up kind of more of a Marvel guy. So, and I love some of the Marvel Netflix. To me, like the gold standard, I like the first season of Daredevil.
Punisher.
I'm getting into this. I love Punisher. Right. I love when Punisher was in the Daredevil. I love all that.
Right.
But this, man, I don't know if it's just new to me. I was blown away by it. I thought the way it's put together, the casting, even the music, everything is done so well. I just got done with the Jason Todd episode.
A great episode.
Just great characters. What about that episode with the Doom Patrol?
Yeah, what do you think?
So
are you gonna watch?
Awesome.
Are you gonna watch Doom Patrol when they spin off to that series next year?
Oh, are they doing that?
Yeah. There's a Doom, but they, so that was them announcing, except for it, Chief is now going to be Timothy Dalton in that series, which is starting next year.
Oh, that's an upgrade.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited about it, too.
Yeah, oh, very, very cool.
So you decided, so Matt, so what made you decide to sign up to the app?
All right, listen, so I was in Florida with my... you know, with the fam, doing the Disney thing, the Universal thing, visiting my father-in-law's hero's got a house over there. So we're hanging out. My brother-in-law, Edwin, he fights also. Big 300-pound dude.
Yeah.
He's into this shit, too. So between me and him, I told you, we got your fucking back. Nobody's getting thrown in the locker. So I'm talking to him about this thing. And so he just downloaded it first. He got it first. And he's watching it. He went through, the day after Thanksgiving, he went through, three episodes, right? He's just sitting there watching it, and he's like, "Hey, man," and I can't because my kids are always on me, and it's, you know, like it's yeah, I gotta sit down and digest it,
right?
So I'm like, "All right, man, I'll give that a chance when I get home." So that was so I got home on a Sunday, you know, and holy shit, man, that's why I wanted to call you. I go, "This is, I got nobody to talk to." I go, "Honey, this is awesome." She's like, "You wait," and my wife's into this shit too. She's like, "You gonna wait for me?" I go, "Ah, it's not that good, so I gotta watch it on my own. I got no time for it." You know, listen, if I have to watch it, that's all the time. But
yeah.
Anyway,
yeah, but
I need somebody to geek out to. So, like, oh, I found myself texting you, Christian. I stopped myself because I don't want to be a fucking weirdo.
Nah, I get it. Dude, you can always shoot me a text about it for sure. Absolutely. I mean, the thing, I actually felt the same way because I was going to, so I went last week, I went to, when I texted you, I was going to see, because the WWE was in town, and I went, and I was there for I forget if it was a SmackDown or whatever it was, and I was in the parking lot when I was texting with you, and I was like, is it weird that I'm sending this guy, like, text now? Yeah. Like, and then I was like, I got to ask him, because the reason why I did that, and I asked, and so we sold out New York in 3 days. It took us about a month.
Oh,
it took us a month and a half to sell out LA. It took us 3 days to sell out New York. And there's going to be 400 screaming geeks that are there. And I asked you, I said, hey, I would love it if you were able to make it, to walk out with one of the fighters. And you said you're going to try.
Now this is the thing. I when you tell me the show, I thought it was going to be like what you guys are doing now, just go in there, sip some espresso, and talk some geeky shit. I didn't know it was like a WWE. Is it like a WWE type thing?
No, no, no. It's basically, if you look at the clip I sent you today, so what it is that...
I started watching that thing.
Yeah.
And don't get me wrong, I'm not shitting on it.
No, 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 no.
I'm not... And I know, like, Sam Roberts is into that shit.
There's a wrestling element as far as, shit-talking, very similar to like what Conor McGregor does, you know? And this is the actual game itself is straight-on movie trivia. And it's like you'll see how intense it gets. People get really intense with there's geeky trivia. There's all this stuff, too. Just watch the actual game itself.
I'm not going to bullshit you. I watched – you sent me just the beginning. You didn't watch – you didn't send me the game.
I sent you the clip. If you go,
I saw a clip of like the WWE type stuff.
Scroll through it.
I'm 100% going to
give them time.
And, man, dude, I'll definitely, as long as there's no like little geek yelling in my face.
No, I don't know.
I don't do the fake stuff.
You'll see.
I'd love to take part. I'm going to check that shit out.
Nonetheless, even if you're not part of it, we'd love to have you there so we can shoot the shit with you to come by the actual event. But I also want to ask you, what else? You seen anything? Oh, that was what we talked yesterday about Venom. Venom in the box office beat Wonder Woman overall yesterday over the weekend. Did you hear about that?
I thought Venom, I enjoyed Venom.
They know.
I mean, it was a little stupid. Hold on, though. But what about when he just goes to changes? Like, I'm just a little, like, his motive, when he, all of a sudden, he's just like, you know what? I'm kind of a loser like you where I'm from. And then, I'm just going to hang out here.
Right.
What the fuck? What?
Right.
Really, Venom? I mean, that's cool, but all right. I don't know.
Yeah.
You think there'd be a little more thought into that? It's kind of funny. I mean, in a funny type of way.
Well, that was my issue. That was my issue with it. Yeah. The issues with the script at this point, it really doesn't matter because the movie has made more, because Wonder Woman made a lot of money for DC. And
it was good. Wonder Woman was very good.
I thought so too. Venom eclipsed
one of the best DC movies.
Well, yeah. So I'll ask you about that. So are you surprised that Venom beat Wonder Woman as far as overall box office goes?
I actually am surprised by that. I thought Wonder Woman kind of killed it, didn't she?
That's the point. So Wonder Woman made, I think it was like
821,
and Venom made 822,
and still going.
So yeah. Venom has a chance, you know, to maybe hit 900. We'll see. The other thing that we were talking about here today was Aquaman. Are you excited for that one? The first couple Twitter responses have been out yesterday. It seems to be getting some pretty positive reviews. James Wan, who did The Conjuring, is doing the movie. And, Aquaman's right around the corner.
Yeah, you know, I'm kind of – I'm going to watch it for sure, man. You know, I support all this. And I like Jason, right?
Jason Momoa.
I think he's awesome, you know. It always throws me off, though, because, I mean, it is what it is, but he just doesn't look like Aquaman to me. But he's the new Aquaman, but it's all good. I'm looking forward to that.
That's what I said.
I'll see that for sure.
I said my dad, who was like, you know, the original, he owned all those like first early stuff. He's watching the trailers for Aquaman, and he's like, I don't know, that doesn't look like the Aquaman I used to read about. And I think that may hurt box office because there's a lot of those old school comic purists are like, I don't see this is the Aquaman I'm used to.
But there's also a lot of Game of Thrones fans and, newbies.
Yeah, it's true.
Hey, really quick, guys. At least I know I got to get my kids out. You guys are into the Clone Wars, no? You're into the TV show?
Absolutely.
The TV show?
Yeah, they're coming back. They're coming back.
I heard that was coming back. Yep. I heard the big thing about it. I never really watched it. So this is really quick. Now, I always wondered why I couldn't get into it. So I went back, and I watched the last season, the first episode, and I thought it was fucking magnificent.
Yep.
It was about the clone trooper that started. He flipped out. He killed the Jedi.
Oh, yeah, that's one of the best.
You know the one I'm talking about?
Absolutely,
yeah. It's one of the best episodes.
When they show the chip. Great.
There's the chip inside of his head.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, it's great.
It was so awesome, and I liked it. So I go, you know what? Let me start this thing from scratch. I realize, now I know, the one thing with the prequels, and it carries over to the Clone Wars show, and these fucking, the stupid-ass fucking robots.
Yeah.
You look like a strong wind could just blow them over to making the stupid jokes.
Roger,
They weren't in that Clone Wars one that I seen that I love so much. But whenever they're around, I don't know.
Yeah, no, there's moments. So the first season, of Clone Wars, like the first two, it kind of goes back and forth on what you're talking about with how it kind of lands inside of that prequel feel that what people didn't like about it. As it progresses into like season two or three, it has more of those moments that you liked about season six. It's got darker moments. It's got a lot of character development. So I would think there are definitely going to be like any other show. There's going to be episodes where you're like, all right, I could have done without one. But there are ones that really hit, and that's why they're bringing it back. They're going to do Disney Plus, which is essentially, you know, what DC's doing, what you just got. DC Plus, they're having three Star Wars shows. There's Clone Wars, there's The Mandalorian, and then there's going to be Cassian Andor. There's those three shows, and that service hits. So I would suggest that you catch up on...
Oh, he's got his own thing? Cassian's got his own thing?
Yeah, it's going to... That'll probably come up in the next couple of years.
And I thought he was cool as hell, but for my own two cents, isn't it kind of weird when you know... Like how the story ends up, like you know what I'm saying.
See, but
like,
I don't know. Not necessarily.
I don't know. I like the I like prequel shit, but the fact that you know that he just dies on that, it's like, all right, well, no. I listen. I can go back and forth on that with my own head. So we got no time for that. I gotta pick up my kid.
Go for
really
it.
Quick though, Christian. Yeah. The DC app. Yeah. I'm preaching to the choir though, because all the nerds out there that are listening have that already. But they should tell a friend, because if this Titan show doesn't keep going on. People are getting Kimura'd in Ashigarami. You understand what I'm saying?
That's good.
I love that shit.
I love it too.
I love it. I can't wait to finish it, man.
Well, good. Listen, hey, go pick up your kid. It was wonderful to have you on again. You let me know anytime you want to come on and shoot the shit, man, and we'll do it after, you know, Transformers and Aquaman come out.
You need them on TV Talk.
You come out and you should go on TV Talk to talk about it as well, too. But you are welcome anytime, my friend.
100%.
And I'll look forward to your text on Sunday.
Got it,
all right, brother.
Take care, gang. Thanks.
Later, buddy. Later on, Matt. There's Matt Serra, everybody. Make sure you check him out on Instagram. It's really, he doesn't do the Twitter as much. So.
Do you think he always has that much energy?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
You guys got to start wrapping it up. We got a show coming in later.
Is that Ken?
That's Ken. can you wrap it up?
Ken Knapsack has officially made.
I'm tired of pressing
Collider Live.
Oh, my God.
First appearance. Get in here.
Bring him in.
Get in here. Where's the mic? You got a mic for him?
Yeah, I got one. You can get a chair.
All right.
Oh my God!
This is epic.
Co-host of the afternoons,
Matt Serra, and
my favorite show,
and Ken Napps.
Thanks, bud.
Oh, hey!
He's got his afternoons T-shirt on and everything.
All right. Is that a Brian Ward special?
No, this is a Kyle Harloff special.
Oh, yeah. Kyle also very good. Yeah, you guys are in shape in that picture.
I'm actually doing Cobster's job since he's out today, so I don't know if I should be in here, but
that's fine.
It's good.
It's nice to see you.
Yeah, I heard Matt Serra.
He's
good
great.
Call. Good call.
He's the best.
Yeah,
he's really good. But you're doing the merino, chewing the gum. I like it.
Yeah, The Justine. I'll get a dance show, a singing show on Comedy Central.
You
should.
What's going on, man? What's the latest? You look sprout.
Yeah. I'm here. I'm here for a little meeting, and then we got the Jedi Council
coming
in today.
We're doing pre-tape today.
What's the meeting?
Today.
Well, I can't tell you that, Rob.
Yeah. Can I come?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Is there anyone else? So everything else good?
Everything's great. Everything's great. Yeah.
Okay. Good. Yeah. It's nice to see you. First time.
I watch this show generally every day.
Generally
every day. When I'm cooking my sausage and making my coffee.
Doing notes of what we're doing wrong.
No. You guys do good. Guys do good stuff.
You do good.
His voice got way too high for me to believe that.
I don't want to get in the way.
Oh, of
that's what I keep telling you.
Oh, it's like what we were talking about yesterday. Like how Brett felt like he was off the show for a couple of weeks, and then he said when he came back that the dynamic.
Yeah.
Is that what you're worried about?
Who's Brett?
Exactly.
But Ken's never gotten in the way of anything else.
No, I don't have much to add anymore. I just do monkey dances
that's true.
At home.
I think there's so much for you to add on this show that there ever was on any other show.
I just don't want to do the news ever again.
We don't have to do the news.
Okay.
Why don't you just come in and just talk? Like, did you have, what'd you do? he can't hear, but the music's playing right now.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
What is that? Oh, yeah. I'm Ken Napsack. These are your Collider Live headlines. Roxy Striar.
Why?
Say more.
So how was your Thanksgiving?
Thanksgiving was great. I cooked my first Thanksgiving meal.
You did?
By myself.
How did it go?
He put
the gum behind his ear, and then they put the thing on the ear.
I'm like John Lennon in the All You Need Is Love video.
Yeah. Right.
All you need is love.
Ken is looking very wall.
He's never been more radio in his life.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah.
Someone at a party was like, sometimes you get too radio. That's
That's what I do.
Right. Who said that? Who says you get to radio?
It was a friend. I'll tell you later.
Okay. All right.
I cooked my first Thanksgiving ever for Grace and I and the dogs. Turkey, ham, stuffing.
Ham as well?
Ham.
Where do you go?
Turkey and ham?
I just figured out.
You just figured it out?
I just figured out. I've become, in my older age, more interested in cooking.
Oh.
Yeah, I do some meth on the side. Yeah. Yeah, I got a bone.
What do you do when you make a turkey for two people?
I cheat a little bit. I didn't get an entire bird, though I've been hunting them pretty good on Red Dead Redemption 2.
Yeah.
I just got some turkey, like, breasts, for lack of a better term. Can we say tits on this show?
Yeah.
So I put it down, and then that I learned to just cook that, and the ham I do all the time.
Yeah,
as you can tell.
But it's very great ham. It's very therapeutic cooking, isn't it?
It's so relaxing. Yeah. And I've always liked it. My old roommate used to tease me, you know, Granny Biscuits. That my favorite food group was purple because I just would unwrap things, and it's a funny joke. But I always liked cooking. I just don't have the time. But stuffing was the most intimidating thing. But I figured it out.
You got it, and it worked out pretty well. See, within a relationship, you can cook. You're in good shape.
You're in good shape.
She tweeted a picture of
your. Did she help? Yeah. Did she cook it?
She's good with desserts. She's just not. Kitchen isn't her favorite spot to be in.
Did you have a pie?
No. We had some vegan, gluten-free peanut butter balls with caramel on it.
See, that sounds ridiculous, but I bet you it was delicious.
It was delicious. Yeah. It got leftovers. Yeah. You're not invited.
No, you didn't bring them.
Isn't peanut butter vegan? Isn't peanut butter vegan? Like vegan, it's peanut butter.
I don't know. You always
well,
say
not if it's the but, butter part of.
But so when you're cooking, I want to know the process for the pit boss
when he's cooking.
Is there music going when you're cooking?
No, usually like a Star War. I put a Star War on in the background.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Put Bret Hart and Natty Neidhart's music on. I'm not an organized person, as you guys know.
Right.
If you worked with me, I have 72 tabs on my screen, and my desktops are always messy. But I get everything down what I need to do, and I formulate a plan. I'm like General Krixmadine in Return of the Jedi. Like, how are we going to take down the second Death Star?
And
by the way, my favorite, Matt Serra is talking about Clone Wars stuff, and there's just a shot of Macuga.
Did you see the one of me?
No.
Well,
from the Schmoedown?
Yeah.
What are you doing? You got cocaine right behind you. It's staring into the void.
I was telling these guys, it's Aaron Wilhelm's fault. And it looks like Ellis is looking at the wrong camera.
Yeah, what is Ellis
going
on?
He's talking to the competitors.
What's going on here?
Yeah, I mean, another.
JT.
Yeah, JT. Yeah. Well, we were talking about some of JT's greatest flubs, right?
Mm-hmm,
Guillermo del Toro.
Yeah.
Trisanotaurus tops.
Yeah.
Geppetto.
You used to say. What did you call him with the? When he hit you, his nickname for Del Toro that you said
Willie the Bull.
Willie the Bull.
No, but he. Oh gosh, what was the one? Me and Stuckman witnessed off camera at Screen Junkies one time, and I can't remember. Oh God, it was so funny. And we repeated it. Yeah, we repeated it on air. I don't know. God bless the guy.
Yeah. It was like Cuba Gooding Jr.
It was like the Cuba Gooding Missile Crisis.
Oh, that's right.
But what a guy. This guy flies off a scooter and lands face first into a mailbox. And
is it a mailbox?
I don't know.
I can see that.
And he is like,
seriously? Yes. I've never seen somebody get back up the way that JT gets back up.
Oh, yeah.
In anything and everything he does. He's always like
He's a video game character.
Yeah.
You smash him with a thing and he just gets back up. And the energy bar goes down a little bit, but he just keeps walking around.
He's the best person in the world.
Ever.
It's a fact. We got to tell that story somehow, some way. He was telling me at a birthday party recently what happened and just have blood's pouring out of his face some good Samaritans like calling Billy Patterson, Billy Business. It's like, I think your man's dead. He ain't coming in. And like Josh was like,
couldn't talk because his teeth were out. Yeah. Huh? Wow. Yeah. He came in here. He was in here a little while ago, and you know, he's recovered, but he looks like he went a couple rounds with Matt Serra.
Yeah.
I mean, he
But he finally got a car, so 50% of my jokes are gone.
No way.
Yeah. Car.
I love this guy. I just missed him. I saw him right there, and I missed him.
He's kind of doing the adult thing. He bought a very expensive dog. A car.
That dog is awesome.
Dalton's kind of dog.
English bulldog.
Yeah, follow it on Instagram.
Brought it in here.
Oh, he's
Dalton the best. Bulldog. The just got those big floppies.
Yeah, he's great.
Yeah. Anyways, you guys got a great show.
When are you coming back in, like for real?
Look, I got. We'll do it soon. I've always told people I would be on.
Yeah, well, you were.
I give an honest answer. No current plans. Number one, I sleep in a lot.
Right.
too. I do have some stuff I want to get the word out about. I just can't officially announce it yet. But we'll come by. I'm trying to get up earlier so I can work out earlier, and maybe that'll put me
out of the auditorium.
At the auditorium.
Right. Well, look, we got.
I bought a medicine ball.
Ken, ooh. Did you? Wow. Yeah. Ken Napsok.
I work out like 1941.
Well, it was a nice to have you. It was nice to finally have you on the show in some capacity. Matt Serra today.
Great
too.
Call.
Now, Jason Aquaman.
Jason Aquaman. Mrs. S.
Mrs. S.
Mrs. S.
A lot of great.
Remember that time?
Nope.
Yeah. Now I want. There's one thing I got to bring up here, and Macuga, take over the show for a second.
Okay. It's great to have Ken here. Here's a hint for and Mark.
Josh, this is a good one. This one, you'll remember this one. Okay. Remember that time we hadn't met yet. Remember that time that we went to the movies and we saw that one, and it was before the trailer for The Phantom Menace.
But you're leaving out the best part. Who was, everyone knows this.
Yeah.
What was the usher wearing that led us into the theater after hours?
Okay. I'm trying to remember, but I can't.
What was the name of the horse?
Ralph. All right. tomorrow, this is something. It's going to be a little controversial. It's just going to be.
Hey, Roxy.
Well, tomorrow, I called Ken about this because I'm going to be a little showing my cards here. I was concerned about this interview that we're doing tomorrow.
An Instagram coach?
It's not an Instagram coach. Thank you, though. so we are going tomorrow, just myself and Roxy, from 11 o'clock to 12 o'clock tomorrow on this show. Actor Lilo Brancato Jr. Now, if you know that name, from Bronx Tale. And from A Bronx Tale and from The Sopranos, Renaissance Man, was an up-and-coming actor, so much praise for his performance in A Bronx Tale, then into Sopranos, and I don't know exactly how old he was. He found himself in a lot of trouble, was in drugs, alcohol got himself into a lot of trouble. One night, he and his friend broke into a house to try to steal some drugs. Friend wound up shooting and killing a police officer. There is a documentary out about Lilo's life called Wasted Talent. Lilo went to jail or prison for about 8 years. He is going to be in here tomorrow to talk about all of that. And it's just going to be Roxy and myself kind of talking to him in general about it. And there's a lot of people who believe he should still be in jail. There's a lot of people, a lot of police officers who, you know, believe that he's just as guilty. But Lilo's trying to get a second step into life here and try to get his career back and everything too. And he's making the rounds. He's coming in to visit us tomorrow, and we'll ask him all these questions. I'm very curious about it.
He's got an interesting life to say the least. So we'll definitely get some interesting moments.
And I'm not gonna hold back. I'm gonna ask all these questions too because it's like this is what the documentary is about. This is what he's doing. You know, this is mm-hmm. stuff like I want to learn, you know.
Well, he's got to face it dead on, and he knows that. And also, you guys also know I read every single comment there ever is. So if you have questions for him, write him in the comments, and I'll make sure that
absolutely, because
bring him up.
We're going to ask about regret. We're going to ask about, you know.
The thing of Bronx Tale they talk about is wasted talent.
That's the whole, and that's where the title of the documentary comes from, too. Chaz Palminteri, I believe, he was in the 60 Minutes report I saw. I don't know if he's in this particular one. But anyway, he's in tomorrow, and that's going to be very – very interesting. So make sure you tune in tomorrow. But for today, Josh Macuga, Mark Reilly, the Pit Boss, Ken Napsok, Roxy Striar, Matt Serra, Cody, Alex. We'll see you. Collider Live.